down with the guitars jamming, that's where we're headed. Straight up to Madison, Wisconsin, singing, Lord, I was born a rambling man.
Pennsylvania to Iowa.
Even Chicago's got one or two hillbillies ready to hit the road. It's a defense and an offense kind of thing. Raise up your hand.
Musical interlude into our primetime presentation tonight. Rascal Flatts with a Big Ten adaptation of their hit, Me and My Gang. The coaches tonight, Brett Bielema into his third season, his fourth season, I should say, at Wisconsin, 28-11. He won 17 of his first 18 here in Madison. For Northern Illinois, Jerry Kill in his second season. In 15 years as a head coach, he's 110-64 his second season in DeKalb at Northern Illinois. Chris, how about some keys to the game?
Well, when you look at Northern Illinois, I think the big thing for them is to match the physicality of the Badgers. Can they hold up, particularly inside? And then expect them to try and get outside on the perimeter with Chandler Harnish. They got to attack the edges of Wisconsin. For Wisconsin, what can Brown do for you? Zach Brown, that is. He proved it in camp that he is the guy. He's going to be toting the mail all day. And defensively, they lost a lot of players, so it's important to create a new identity.
Phillip Welch has the ball on the tee. And we are underway. Welcome to this Big Ten primetime presentation. Welch puts it through the end zone. Third member of our crew on hand here tonight, Carissa Thompson. Carissa, how you doing?
I am doing fantastic, guys. Good to see you again. The year was 2006, Brett Bielema's first year as head coach for the Badgers. He was in Chicago for Big Ten Media Day with then-Badger star Joe Thomas. Joe looked at his new coach and said, they don't think we're going to be that good. And coach said, it's when teams aren't expected to do that great when they do their best. They finished the season 12-1. Jay Belai is looking to have that same success this year. He said the key to this year is all about redemption.
No question, Carissa. First down, Northern Illinois. Miko Brown spilled across the 25 of the 27, gain of 7 yards. The quarterback in his sophomore year out of Bluffton, Indiana, Chandler Harnish, a great athlete. He's a two-way threat. He burst on the scene a year ago at Minnesota and nearly engineered an upset of the Gophers in the start of the final season in the Metrodome.
No question about it. He led the team in rushing and in passing. He is certainly a dual threat guy.
Second down. Brown again. Nice hole right up the gut. He's got a first down to the 33-yard line. Now for the Rotel Velveeta starting lineup, because you can't start your game day without their famous queso dip. Brown is a scat back type. Nathan Palmer as a receiver downfield, had a huge game at Minnesota a year ago, but Willie Clark is the go-to guy. And up front, Anye Buagu and Adamski in the middle of that line are outstanding. They just opened the last hole that gave Northern a 1st and 10. Opening drive of the game. Harnish, that's Palmer, and that's a 1st down. Beg your pardon, not Palmer, but on that reception, Marcus Lewis for 11 yards. The Wisconsin defense, and there's some question marks up front. They had to restructure this year. Schofield and Watt, two outstanding defensive ends to keep an eye on, especially that sophomore, J.J. Watt. They redid the linebacking core. Mike Taylor, the coach is excited about him, a redshirt freshman. In the secondary, you've got Jay Belai, who is a hitter at the safety spot. First down to the 44 of Northern. Brown nowhere to go. We spoke of him a moment ago. Mike Taylor, the redshirt freshman out of Ashwaubenon, Wisconsin, a loss of four. Second down coming up for Northern.
Oh, and it's funny when we get into meetings and you talk to coaches about players, and when we threw out the name Mike Taylor, you could just see him light up. The antennas go up. They think this guy has a chance to be something special. He's a seek and destroy type of linebacker, extremely athletic, and he makes a lot of plays.
Lewis at the top of your screen. They've got a slot at the bottom. Second down, passing situation for Harnish. Harnish rolling. Landon Cox chased down out of bounds in front of the Wisconsin bench at the Badger 48-yard line. 13-yard gain. Javery McFadden, the outside linebacker, the man they worked out.
And Wayne, you can expect to see a lot of this tonight. What you want to do is roll Chandler Harnish out. He's very comfortable throwing the ball on the run. We talked to the offensive coordinator, Matt Limegrover. He said he's got to get him outside on the perimeter and find his target.
Same thing with the running game, too, right? We're going to see stretch plays. We're not going to see them go right at the defense necessarily.
Exactly. A lot of pulling guards.
Third down and short. Brown. Boy, he's hard to find, and he very nearly slithered for the first down. I believe he's going to be a yard short on a gain of a yard and a half on that play.
He's about 5'7", standing on a phone book. But what he does do is he gets his shoulder square, and it's hard to see him in traffic, and he has good leg drive. I think he'll be short of the first down. Watch the cut. Keeps his legs moving.
He had a sliver of a hole there, and after some delay, Jerry Kill finally sends on the punting unit. He was thinking about it, apparently, going for it on fourth and one.
But if you're Coach Kill, you're happy with that start. And they did some things, moving the ball in the air. They hit a quick slant route. They were able to run between the tackles. So that's a very auspicious start for the Huskies.
Josh Wilbur on in punt formation. Straight on, Gilreath from the 14. Oh, collared high. I do not see a flag, but a high tackle attempt. Patrick George took down the return man, David Gilreath. Just a 6-yard return off a 23-yard punt.
And if you watch it, Gilreath's got room. Look at what he sees. Just an excellent play to bring him on the ground, because Gilreath is one of those guys. He's special with the ball in his hands. That's a good play in the open space. You got to stop him before he gets started.
Badgers for the first time on offense. Early going, first quarter, no score. Zach Brown, the long setback. Tolzien to the air. Oh, and he's got a man wide open. Down the sidelines, going all the way to the end zone. Isaac Anderson, 80 yards.
Tolzien saying, you question my arm strength? Watch this. Play action pass, blown coverage, and Isaac Anderson on just a takeoff route, running naked, as we like to say, wide open, counted for six.
The extra point is good by Philip Welch. Wisconsin on a one-play blast takes the lead in the first quarter.
Penn Network.
What a way to start. Anderson, the recipient of an 80-yard touchdown pass from Tolzien. Take a look at it, Chris. Was this zone coverage?
Well, no question about it. When you look at the stance here by the corner, he's flat-footed, expecting cover two. He's got a carry. There's two guys going vertical. If we can stop it right there, you'll see the safety right here. His vision's on the inside guy. He's got a trail with the outside cut. The corner just misses it, and that's how Anderson becomes wide open.
And from there, it was pitch and catch. Tell you.
Curtains.
Here's the kickoff. And again, a good strong kick. And coming out of there is Davis. Tommy Davis did well to get back near the 20-yard line. The American Football Coaches Association of America has asked college football teams on the FBS level to meet at the 50-yard line in a show of sportsmanship prior to the games this opening weekend. This was the scene earlier tonight, Northern Illinois and Wisconsin. And this is a good gesture and a message being sent by the Coaches Association. First and 10 for Northern Illinois. Nothing there. Right off the get-go, J.J. Watt. And nothing doing for Chad Spann.
And I'll tell you right now, this is what you want your defensive ends to look like. J.J. Watt is 6'6", about 290. Wisconsin just hadn't had that type of end when you look at his measurables, but obviously you can tell he has explosiveness coming off the edge. A powerful defensive end.
Second and 10. Harnish. Willie Clark, and right away, Aaron Henry, the sophomore, made the hit.
Well, and the great thing about this play is you watch his transition quicks. Now, he's coming off of an ACL last season, so you love to see that burst out of his break and able to close in on the receiver quickly. They love this kid's ability. He's a long, linear corner at 6 foot. You see it right there, and that's what you want in a corner. Athletic enough, though, to come up and have saran wrap coverage.
Third down and 6. Badgers in a blitz. They picked it up well. Harnish could not find a receiver downfield, and down he goes. Blake Sorensen, who lost his outside linebacking job to Mike Taylor, in on the third down package on the blitz, gets the quarterback for a loss of 7, and it's fourth down.
You talk about getting home. That was great coverage on the back end by the Wisconsin secondary, allowing Sorensen to corral Chandler Harnish. Defensive back's best friend is a good pass rush. That time we saw it through a blitz package.
Wilbur in punt formation. Booming kick. Gilreath, fearless. Dancing inside the 35. Now gets the turn. Out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Did a lot of running east-west to get about 4 yards on that return. Now for the Rotel Velveeta starting lineup, because you can't start your game day without their famous queso dip. Zach Brown, somewhat of a surprise start at the running back spot. A lot of people thought John Clay would get the call. You saw Anderson on the last drive. Garrett Graham, an All-America caliber tight end. Up front, there's the freshman center, Travis Frederick, a true freshman center playing for the injured John Moffitt.
Keep an eye on that matchup inside.
Brown gets a block, and not much more. Hit by Tracy Wilson, a redshirt sophomore out of Harvey, Illinois. For Northern Illinois, defensively, and we look at them up front, they've lost Larry English to the NFL. Jake Kaufman, an ex-Marine, replaces English on that line. Brandon Bice will have to press the pocket. Kuba, Schiller, and Hansen, more safety size than linebacker. And then you get a look at the secondary. David Bryant is an all-MAC caliber safety. Second down. Tolzien. Into the seam, got Garrett Graham. First down, 40-yard line of the Huskies. 17-yard gain. Tracy Wilson made the stop.
And that's vintage Wisconsin football. They come in, two tight ends, and you know when they're going to air it out to a tight end, it's going to be Garrett Graham. You see him working, finds a nice little window in the defense, hits the seam, knows where to sit down. And that's what Coach Bielema likes about Tolzien. He was very decisive with the ball. He knew exactly where he wanted to go, put the ball in the numbers.
He's been better than that so far. Penalty markers down here. The thing about Tolzien, folks, they really, Kurt Phillips
ball
is
start,
the guy.
68 offense, 5-yard penalty, down remains number one.
To be honest with you, when I was here 3 weeks ago at practice, Kurt Phillips was running with the number one team, the redshirt freshman out of Kingsport, Tennessee. Now, we're going to see Kurt Phillips in the ball game here tonight. There's no question about that. But he was the guy they were hoping would win the job. He did not. Scott Tolzien did, or the coaches told us yesterday time and time again. It's not that Phillips lost the job. Tolzien won it because he can execute the offense a little more consistently right now. Zach Brown gets back to the 42-yard line, a gain of about 3 yards.
Well, and Wayne, I think you said it perfectly. He's consistent. The one word that you could not use to describe Wisconsin quarterbacks last season was consistency. And I think for Tolzien, he stepped in, he's demonstrated leadership capabilities, and right now, 2 for 2, 97 yards, he's been very accurate with the football.
Second down and about 12 for Wisconsin. There's a look at Kurt Phillips. We'll see him. And Brett Bielema will make a change at quarterback in the first quarter for a series or so. Quick toss to the flank. Nick Toon, oh, wrapped up beautifully. Form tackle made by Patrick George, who was the cornerback who really broke coverage on the 80-yard touchdown pass on the last Wisconsin drive to Isaac Anderson.
And most certainly did. As bad as he played that earlier fade route, this was equally as impressive. You'll watch him come underneath the block on this bubble screen. Watch him dip right underneath and make a play. That is an excellent play in the open field on Nick Toon by Patrick George.
If you recognize the name Toon, his dad Al starred here at the UW with Randy Wright at quarterback under Dave McClain and a couple of bowl trips back in the 80s. Tolzien screens it out. Brown caught from behind. Brown was trying to be patient, wait for his blocking, but quick to the ball, Alex Baxter. Baxter is a true freshman out of Buffalo Grove, Illinois. These are two fairly young football teams. Gain of about 4 on that play, and it's fourth down for Wisconsin.
And they want to get Zach Brown into the game early. You talked about just how he competed in camp. And then talking to Coach Bielema, he said he just had a sense of urgency, which is how he beat out John Clay.
Phillip Welch will try a 55-yard field goal on a beautiful night here in Madison off the left hash. And it is no good. 5:48 left to go, first quarter. Wisconsin, on the benefit of an 80-yard touchdown pass, has the lead. Welcome back to Madison. Chandler Harnish and company take over first and 10, trailing 7-0 at the Northern Illinois 38-yard line. Three receivers set, two at the top of your screen. This is Miko Brown. Oh, great move on Aaron Henry. Brown down the sidelines on the cutback. He stumbles into the clear and down he goes at the 15-yard line of Wisconsin. 47 yards downfield.
Miko Brown said, hey, Zach, go Brown. He's a guy. Watch this. Get that stretch play. We talked about it. Get outside. Now watch the move on Henry. I mean, he just undressed him. He's missing a piece of his uniform.
You were asking what can Brown do for you a lot on both sides of the ball here. I tell you. First down. Brown hit in the backfield and covered up. O'Brien Schofield first to the ball. Loss of 1. Big Ten College Football is brought to you in high definition by Phillips HD. Available at Target, Walmart, and Sam's Club.
You know, Wisconsin's showing some man coverage, so once you get past that first layer, the field becomes wide open, evidenced by that run by Miko Brown.
Three at the top of your screen. Harnish alone in the shotgun. Now gets motion from Chad Spann to the backfield and gives it to Spann. Gets by Schofield. Spann gets what he can down to the 14-yard line. He basically tripped on his own. And then Colmer St. Jean got there to make a hit. It's a gain of about 3.
A gain of 3, but a great play call. Yeah, I like the misdirection action. You put Chad Spann in, who's a little bit of a bigger back. He's about 200 pounds, so a little bigger than Miko. And what does he do? He gets in there, he runs straight ahead. We're seeing the offensive coordinator of Northern Illinois, Matt Limegrover, keep Wisconsin off balance. He's mixing in nice pass plays, good runs between the tackle, but he's also getting the ball outside, which is the recipe against playing Wisconsin.
Now it's third down. Scarb, the man in motion. Play action. Under pressure immediately off the blitz. And the quarterback, Harnish, is down back outside the 20-yard line. Chris Maragos came free on the blitz from the safety spot. And a loss of 8 yards brings the field goal unit onto the field.
Well, and I love this kid. Hey, you talk about a walk-on that just fights and fights and fights. You saw it earlier. He corralled his group. He was getting them up. And what a play. He shoots the gap. He keeps working. He gets to Harness, who's not easy to bring down. Puts a lot of heat on him.
40-yard field goal attempt to the uprights. And the Groza Award candidate, Mike Salerno, has it right down the boulevard. The Huskies are on the board in Madison.
Crisonic Field
HD, made to feel, made to amaze. Philips HD, made to move you.
Lake Monona, beautiful capital city of Wisconsin. Madison, Wisconsin, there's the state house there in the background. Mike Salerno, 39-yard field goal. Put Northern on the board. Here's his kickoff. This is Gilreath. To the 25-30. Upended across the 40-yard line. Chris Smith brought him down. Excellent return for David Gilreath of 34 yards, and the Badgers have field position.
Wayne, we're going to go back to that last play with Maragos. Now watch it here. Sometimes offensive linemen, it's hard for them to block the smaller guys on the rush. Now, Anya Buwagu, you see him creeping down. Stop it again. He's their best offensive lineman, and that's a one-on-one block. Maragos does a nice job of getting past him. That's why you have to have great footwork if you're an offensive lineman, one-on-one, being able to stay with those smaller, agile players like Maragos.
First and 10, Badgers. Hendricks, the tight end, in motion. This is John Clay for the first time tonight. A gain of about 3 yards. U.S. Marine Corps, leader of the game. And for Wisconsin, no question about it, Scott Tolzien. What a start.
Well, and he's demonstrated poise. I mean, he's come in, he's shown that he's decisive with the football. He understands the offense, and he's shown great command.
Clay, who rushed for over 800 yards a season ago, is the lone setback. Now Hendricks joins him. Clay waited for his block off the left side and got what he could. Kevin Zeitler, the sophomore out of Waukesha, laid the block, and that's the move that Clay cut right behind and gained about 5 yards, leaving a third down just short of the midfield marker.
And then when you look at Clay, he's a big kid. He's a thick, stronger, lower unit type of guy at 247 pounds. But he doesn't always run that big. And I think that's what the coaches want to see from him. Get your shoulder pads down, get square, and push the pile.
Clay again. First down. Inside the 45-yard line of Northern Illinois. Gain of 6.
And we talked to the coaches, and they said, well, he was 250 last season, John Clay, that is. Now he's down to 247, 245-ish, but he's really reconstructed his body. And when you look at him, he's a lot tighter, a little more chiseled, and I think that's added to the strength.
He was telling Brett Bielema going into the fall camp, he said, listen, I want to come in at about 237, and Brett said, you'll be lucky to be under 250, and he was. Brett's got it right. He's about 245 right now, but he looks good. And he gets it again. And this time they collapse on him. In the hole, Adam Coleman, a defensive tackle, made the first hit, gain of 1 yard.
And this is vintage Wisconsin football. And that's the matchup that we're talking about. Can Northern Illinois match the physicality in the trenches? Keep in mind, offensive linemen for Wisconsin, they lost 3 a season ago, from a season ago. Northern Illinois, a little smaller, a little undersized up front. Can they continue to hold up at the point of attack?
Wisconsin is 300-plus across the front line. The small guy is Zeitler. He's 301 at 6'4". Second down and 9. Hendricks in motion. Tolzien, a short drop. Gets it out to Anderson, just inside the 40. Play pretty well diagnosed. Alex Kuba was there defensively. Patrick George in the neighborhood as well.
And I thought the one major deficiency in the offense outside of quarterback last year with Wisconsin was wide receivers. To me, they had just guys. They were waiting for somebody to step up and be special. Travis Beckham disappeared for a lot of the season, couldn't find him, but they want Nick Toon and Isaac Anderson to step up, and so far Anderson's certainly lived up to it.
They were only seventh of the Big Ten in third down conversions a year ago. Tolzien looking here on third down, got a man wide open, and it's Anderson again for a first down to the 23-yard line of Northern Illinois. 13-yard gain, and again he beat Patrick George.
George is, he's been busy. I mean, you look at the cushion there, that's just stealing. Isaac Anderson runs a little curl route. You got to snuggle up to those wide receivers of Wisconsin. Simply can't give them that much room.
One quarter in the books at Camp Randall. A one-play, 80-yard drive to start the first offensive possession for Wisconsin, and the Badgers lead.
Guys, we need to talk. I know we're back at school now, but you're going a little overboard with the new phones.
Yeah.
Mom, just because we're Facebook friends does not mean you can write "I love you" all over my wall.
You know what? Other people can see that.
Dad, cool it with the Twitter updates, okay?
I'm sitting on the patio.
I know you're sitting on the patio.
Now at the back-to-school sale, get great deals on messaging phones for the family, like the Motorola Rilo for $29.99. Verizon Wireless.
Tennessee Williams spoke through stories. Michael Wilbon speaks with perspective. Charlene Barshefsky speaks through diplomacy. Gerald Ford spoke of world peace. Find your voice.
Let me tell you why you need to watch football in HD. For the one-handed grabs, for those naked bootlegs, and all the punishing hits. Hold up. You're not watching football in standard def, are you? Only DirecTV brings you every NFL game in crystal clear HD. Real funny, fellas. Real funny.
Get every game, every Sunday, all in high def. At NFL Sunday Ticket and Superfan today.
Everything I do is to protect what we got.
How do we want to do this?
You love the man. You learn to love the club.
Just dropping by to give you a little friendly advice.
Nobody threatens Sam Crow.
Sons of Anarchy premieres Tuesday at 10, only on FX.
Weekday afternoons, catch a can't-miss block of programming on the Big Ten Network. Beginning at 3 Eastern, go on campus to see what's new across the Big Ten with 2 full hours of the University Showcase. Then at 5 Eastern, get the inside story on the football season from the men in charge with an hour of coaches' shows. And at 6, relive the magical games from years past on the Big Ten's greatest games. It's all weekdays starting at 3 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Tomorrow night, there's only one show that covers everything Big Ten. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Mike Hall and Melanie Collins bring you a complete recap of the week that was across the conference. Highlights, in-depth interviews, football analysis from Chris Martin, and your first look at what lies ahead next week. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Tomorrow night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. 10 Football Breakdown, presented by Polaris, Tuesday at 10 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
Y'all get your hands together!
Straight up to Madison, Wisconsin, singing, Lord, I was born a rambling man.
Wayne Larrabee, Chris Martin, Carissa Thompson, primetime football to the Big Ten Network. Here comes Isaac Anderson again to the end zone! Touchdown!
And I think Wisconsin is finding their go-to wide receiver. Isaac Anderson, we've seen him already running great routes with detail. This is just a simple reverse. You see the fast-flowing Northern Illinois defense pursuing down hard, allowing that play to get outside on the perimeter. Now, if you're an edge guy for Northern Illinois, you have to force that back inside. That's where the help is.
Phillip Welch for the punt after. He banged that one in. Isaac Anderson, 80 yards on the first offensive snap of the season for Wisconsin on a touchdown bomb. And then just moments ago, 23 yards on a reverse and the extra point. That was close.
Gotta make life interesting.
Wisconsin leads it 14-3. Early going, just underway, second quarter.
When we talk about the emergence of Isaac Anderson, and he's played faster than I thought he was. And we'll see the reverse again. Watch all the white jerseys inside. Great blocking up front by the Big Hogs. And again, if you're Northern Illinois, you cannot let that out the chute. You gotta force it back inside. Now, granted, Anderson does an excellent job of sniffing that end zone and getting to the pylon.
He has good speed, though, Chris. Isaac Anderson set the Minnesota State record with a 10.9 400 meter dash in high school. He came on late last season, had 16 receptions and 243 yards over the final seven games. Those are the numbers of the first half. Big plays highlighted that first half, a first quarter, I should say, for Wisconsin. And Northern Illinois had a 47-yard running play in that mix.
And Anderson, not just a track guy, he plays faster than his time speed.
Davis from the five. Just short of the 30-yard line. Devin Smith made the hit, and it's a first down coming up off a 25-yard return for Tommy Davis.
I expect to see Northern Illinois coming out here and taking some chances in this series, trying to get down the field to loosen up what has been a very stalwart defense for Wisconsin, particularly inside.
And Chris, you expect them to attack Wisconsin on the flanks, right, for the most part?
Exactly. Get outside. You see it now. We got trips. Expect Northern Illinois to take some shots in this drive.
First down from the Husky 29. Miko Brown trying to follow Adamski on a move off right guard, and he took it off the left side of his center for about 4 yards. Go inside the conference 4 nights a week with 4 unique shows on the Big Ten Football 4-Pack. Our experts bring you game plan breakdowns, interviews, and analysis you won't find anywhere else. Catch the Football 4-Pack every Tuesday through Friday, 10 o'clock Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network, the only cure for gridiron deficiency. Second down. Harnish, quick throw. And they've got a first down. Kyle Scarb, the fullback, on the reception, a gain of 7 yards. Jay Valai and Antonio Finellas on the stop for Wisconsin. First down for Northern Illinois, just across the Husky 41.
Scarb showing some hands there. Not just a big plug guy moving bodies. Nice job pulling that ball in. But Northern Illinois, when you play against Wisconsin, you got to empty your playbook. We're seeing option, we're seeing throws to the fullback. They are mixing up the play call.
First and 10. Brown. Not much there. O'Brien Schofield at the root of the problem for the Huskies. Gain of about 1 yard.
And when you look at Wisconsin's front four, I mean, this defensive line averages 282 pounds. They were about 20 pounds less collectively last season. So you expect them to be more physical at the point. Maybe not as fast flowing, but certainly can anchor.
Second down.
Look at these linebackers, they're cheating up.
To Miko Brown. Schofield in the backfield blew the play up. Schofield is a senior from Great Lakes, Illinois. Former linebacker, and he looked like a linebacker on that play. No gain.
No doubt about it. He's one of those hybrid type linebackers. You watch it here, right in the frame. Look at that. Open field, able to cut with Miko Brown. And what you saw there is him put his foot in the ground and redirect. That is an excellent open field tackle on a very slippery running back.
Third down and still 8. You get the feeling Northern needs to move the chains another time here to give that defense a rest.
They've got to loosen up this defense.
They're 0-for-3 on third down conversions. Harnish, option, Brown. Tried to get wider than wide, but could not, and a flag down on the play, maybe a face mask. against Wisconsin. It could be on McFadden on the high tackle attempt.
Brown was seeing red.
Personal foul, face mask, 47 defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Just what the doctor ordered for the Huskies.
Yeah, that's pretty, that's an easy call. And let Northern Illinois off the hook because that was surrounded. Look at all those guys there. He had nowhere to go with the football. Bailed him out.
So the football moves inside Wisconsin territory to the 42-yard line. I don't think Brett Bielema has much of a beef there. And I don't think he's beefing about it either.
You won't see him beef about aggressive plays.
Harnish on a first and 10. Good protection. Oh, and he's got his big tight end over the middle for a first down and then some. Brian Beckner, the junior from Bourbonnais, Illinois, on a 27-yard gain to the 15 of Wisconsin.
Nice play call by Matt Limegrover. Even better execution by Chandler Harness. It's just a simple seam route. Good job of splitting, getting in between the linebacker and the safety. Harness puts the ball again right on the numbers. Tight spiral. Maragos comes in. Move the chains.
Huskies first down at the 15-yard line of Wisconsin. They empty the backfield and put Harnish in the shotgun. Three receivers top of your screen, one to the bottom. Harnish on a quarterback draw, but they weren't buying it up the middle. Oh, what a great play made by J.J. Watt. He snuffed it out, and he smelled it coming all the way. Take a look at tonight's Auto Owners Insurance game leaders. Miko Brown had a 47-yard run to set up the field goal score. Tolzien has been magnificent, and Isaac Anderson even better than that.
I would throw J.J. Watt in there, too. He splashed some big plays. Defensive end, again, 6'6", 290. Not your prototype DN size for Wisconsin. A lot bigger.
Watts, a defensive end toward the top of your screen. Miko Brown, and boy, there's just not much whenever they've gone up the middle. J.J. Watt in on that stop again. And you get a look at number 99 right there, J.J. Watt. He's a transfer out of Central Michigan. I asked Brett Bielema yesterday, how did this kid, who was All-State in Wisconsin, get away from you guys? And Bielema said, well, he was 6'2 and about, what, 197 pounds when he came out.
240. He's now almost 300.
Yeah.
Good-looking kid.
Late bloomer. Quick toss on the flank. This is Willie Clark. And there were too many Badgers in the neighborhood. They had it set up on a bubble screen, but snuffed out by the Badgers. Outstanding play. Made by the linebacker, Blake Sorensen.
Well, and you get the sense that Wisconsin is starting to create a defensive identity. Keep in mind, they lost a lot of special players last year. Shaughnessy, Newkirk, Chapman, the linebackers, Casillas and Levy. They're finding that identity on defense.
29-yard field goal attempt, Mike Salerno. And it is good. Couple of drives for Jerry Kill's Huskies into Badger territory have netted 6 points. We're still second quarter, the Badgers on top by 8.
So what's the problem?
These are hot. We're shipping them everywhere.
But we can't predict our shipping costs.
Dallas, Detroit, different rates.
Well, with us, it's the same flat rate.
Same flat rate.
Boston, Boise?
Same flat rate.
Alabama, Alaska?
With priority mail flat rate boxes from the Postal Service, if it fits, it ships anywhere in the country for a low flat rate.
Dude's good.
Dude's real good.
Dudes.
Priority mail flat rate boxes. Only from the Postal Service. A simpler way to ship.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few. Proud. The Marines.
Where were you the night of the 23rd?
I told you I was on Route 30 heading west in my car.
You're lying! You killed a man!
No, I didn't. I'm telling the truth.
You're not telling the truth, and this courtroom deserves to know!
Jordan, what are they doing?
Badgering the witness.
What's the point? I mean, we're in Wisconsin this week, so.
It's their mascot, badgering the witness. Keep going, this is great.
I need to know the facts!
You can't handle the facts!
Big Ten Friday Night Tailgate, presented by Rotel and Velveeta.
Big Ten Networks,
Big Ten Football 4-Pack.
What's the first rule of the 4-Pack?
Never talk about the 4-Pack.
Tuesday, breakdown game analysis inside and out.
Wednesday,
sights and sounds, scoop for the Big Ten coaches.
Thursday,
behind the schemes, insider look at the X's and O's.
Friday, Big Ten Football and beyond. What's the second rule of the 4-Pack? Never talk about the 4-Pack!
Okay, this never happened.
Watch the Football 4-Pack every Tuesday through Friday night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Welcome back to Madison. Now the students are here for the holiday weekend. Football underway in these parts. This is the nightcap of the Big Ten holiday weekend, the opening of the season. Great to have you with us, Wayne Larrabee, Chris Martin, Carissa Thompson. Mike Salerno has it on the tee, sent to restart the game. Wisconsin leading by 8. Gilreath backs up to the goal line. Here he comes. Hit by George of the 15, plays off of that tackle attempt, gave up yardage, and then is roped down by Spencer Williamson. Check in with Dave Redson in our Big Ten Network studios for a Prestone game break. Dave?
Okay, Wayne, a week of adversity, as you know, for Michigan, and the Wolverines made a fairly emphatic statement against Western Michigan. The freshman, Tate Forcier, 3 passing touchdowns, including that one to Junior Hemingway, 31-7. Michigan rolls.
Thank you very much, Dave. And you saw Tate Forcier during the spring drills on the Big Ten Tour. Here's another freshman coming on, Kurt Phillips out of Kingsport, Tennessee. Tennessee Gatorade Player of the Year. First down at his 13-yard line. Zach Brown alone back. Brown into a crowd, pile driving across the 15 to the 18-yard line. Carissa Thompson, we've had a lot of action, some big plays both ways in this game. What's the mood on the floor of the stadium?
You're not kidding. You guys, Scott Tolzien literally hurdled the bench on his way into the game for his first series as the Badgers starting quarterback. I don't think Brett Bielema would have been too happy with that. However, he probably was happy with the result when he got into the end zone for a touchdown. The mood on the sideline is pure energy. Jay Valai, who said this season had to be about redemption, is talking things up. Chris Maragos has been nonstop since the pregame, guys.
Thank you, Carissa. Zach Brown for a first down, close to the 30-yard line. You know, Carissa was talking about Jay Valai. If you look up the word energy in the dictionary, there's a color picture of Jay Valai right over the word.
And if you look up hard hitter in the dictionary, it's Jay Valai on a
He's
different
in there
page.
A lot, isn't he?
He will take your face off.
11 yards of that gain by Zach Brown, who's starting to get into a rhythm. Kurt Phillips, the redshirt freshman, so much talk about him in this fall camp. And he was the starting quarterback up until the last scrimmage, when he had some accuracy problems, some interceptions, and Scott Tolzien got the call for the start. Brown, a nice hole, and you see the way he can explode through that hole. Gain of 9 yards. Now for the Rotel Velveeta combination of the game, because you can't win without the perfect partner. These two guys, that's updated in their career through tonight's game. Pretty good combination.
Yeah, no doubt. You still get the sense with these quarterbacks that there's some form of audition going on. I mean, you want to see what they can do. You've seen it in practice. How do they perform in real life situations?
Brown, the lone back, he gets the call and got just enough for the first down. Good penetration made by Brian Lawson. Lawson's a redshirt freshman out of Park Forest, Illinois, and he slowed up the runner. It's a gain of 2, first and 10 at the Badger 40-yard line.
Remember, the defensive line for Northern Illinois no longer have Larry English, who was drafted the 16th pick overall in the NFL draft a season ago. So they're hoping guys can step up. Brandon Weiss, number 56, is one of the ones that they're hoping can make some plays to replace Larry English.
First down. Phillips. Off the hands of Toon and nearly caught by Garrett Graham at the 45-yard line of Northern Illinois.
Nick Toon, you know he's got great bloodlines. You see him going up with the football there. He's got to make that catch. He's a long linear receiver. Wasn't a great throw, but certainly a catchable ball.
Oh, yeah.
What Nick Toon gives you is size. He's long, big catching radius, so that you hope for a quarterback like Phillips, he can hit that target.
Second and 10. Boy, Toon's a good looking receiver, though.
Sure is.
I mean, he looks good coming off the bus. Timeout on the field taken by Wisconsin.
Timeout, Wisconsin. First time out of the half.
Anthony Canella is the referee we'll be hearing from tonight. We've got a break. Wisconsin with a 14-6 lead, 7-12 left to go, first half.
Being there means helping you afford everything a true fan needs. That's why State Farm has so many ways to save. So there's more for the little things.
Made from fresh tomatoes living happily together with spicy green chilies. The bold flavor of Rotel gives your queso a kick. Spice things up with Rotel.
Limited time only. Lease a 2010 XF for $599 at your local Jaguar dealer.
Next Saturday on the Big Ten Network, it's a non-conference showdown in Happy Valley when Evan Royster and the Nittany Lions square off with Syracuse. Next Saturday in High Def, presented by the United States Marine Corps, only on the Big Ten Network.
You can create your own football highlight reels each week with the Big Ten Football Mashup presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. Go to mashup.bigtennetwork.com right now to compile your favorite plays and share them with your friends.
Hi, I'm Barry Alvarez, and you're watching the Big Ten Network.
Win a trip to the bowl game of your choice. Enter the Rotel Bowl Bound Sweepstakes on your mobile text. Just text Rotel 202-84, and maybe you'll be bowl bound. This is what he brings to the party. That's the upside right now of Kurt Phillips, the redshirt freshman out of Kingsport, Tennessee. And a quick gain of 7 yards and a move straight up the middle to the 47-yard line of Wisconsin.
Yeah, you said it exactly right. He has those athletic traits, particularly ones when he can use his feet and get inside, outside. He's a great runner. Good size kid as well, 6'3", 228. So you know he's not afraid to tuck it in. Nice alternative and compliment to Scott Tolzien.
Third down and 3. Badgers are 2 of 3 on third down conversions. Nice throw, Garrett Graham. First down, 42-yard line of the Huskies. Back to the studio, Dave Revson with a Prestone game break.
Okay, Wayne, Iowa and Northern Iowa came down to this. Northern Iowa could win the game with this field goal, but Iowa blocked it just moments after they had blocked a previous attempt. Northern Iowa got another try for reasons that are far too complex to explain in the next 3 seconds. We'll talk about it at halftime.
Thank you, Dave. Special teams, partner. They come up big on opening weekends. Phillips out of bounds. Able to beat Chris Smith, the cornerback.
Well, he's certainly not a guy that you're going to arm tackle. Watch Nick Toon here, though, on the crackback. Sizing him up. What a block there. That's what springs the play. You mentioned how big and physical Nick Toon is. That's how they work him into the offense. And I like it. A guy with a temperament, just not looking to catch the ball. He'll set the blocks up as well.
And you know, the thing about Toon on that really good form on that block, I mean, he made sure it was a legal block coming back into the zone. Second down. Brown. Penalty marker is down. Chris Smith, Brandon Bice on the tackle. Would be a first down pending the outcome of the flag, and it was a seemingly late flag, Chris.
Yeah. But what you saw there is Coach Bielman looks.
Holding, 72 offense, 10-yard penalty, still second down.
We'll get a nice shot here.
This is Travis Frederick, right?
Yep.
Big freshman.
The big freshman.
Oh, my goodness.
That'll qualify as a tackle, I think.
He'll come down.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, that's his first Big Ten penalty.
Yeah. He's the first lineman, for sure, I believe, in Wisconsin to start an opener as a true freshman. So you expect to see a little bit of that.
Badgers have been penalized three times for 30 yards. Now facing second and long. Phillips off the hands of Garrett Graham. That ball just a little too tall for the 6'4 tight end.
Yeah, it had a little fire on it, but when you look at Graham, you got to complete that pass. I mean, he's too wide open. You want to put the balls right between that 8 and 9 there. Put it on him. Garrett Graham, I like what he gives you. Travis Beckham was a good player. We all know that. But I think that he had limitations. This kid doesn't have limitations. He's a pure quintessential tight end. Big body, can block, also catch the ball very effectively.
They feel he's a complete tight end. Badgers, 3 of 4 on third downs, third and long. Phillips. Graham, short of the first down, just inside the Husky 40.
Remember that Wisconsin, they throw the ball to their tight ends 40% of the time. That's the most in the FBS. So Garrett Graham, he's a great pass catching tight end. As we mentioned, you expect those tight ends to be able to work the routes. That went a little short of the sticks. He's a special tight end. I mean, you talk about Owen Daniels, who's now playing for the Houston Texans. This kid's right in that same mold. Very good football player.
Brad Nortman.
Look at this
on a punt formation
lineup here.
Yeah, they've got three protectors for the punter. Oh, and it backs up nicely like a wedge on a soft green, and the Badgers down it inside the 20-yard line of Northern Illinois.
Your wedge.
Moving right along in the second quarter. Field them on the Badgers on top.
Introducing the fastest accelerating, most agile side-by-side in the world. The new Ranger RZR. The wait is over. RZR-sharp side-by-side performance. See it up close at your local Polaris Ranger dealer.
We believe there's something to be said for setting goals and achieving them. For dreaming big and getting there. For hearing biological clocks and listening. For clocking long hours, sacrificing, and succeeding. And for finally being able to say, welcome home. We are independent agents proudly representing Auto Owners Insurance Company. Currently ranked highest in customer satisfaction for the auto insurance claims experience by J.D. Power & Associates.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Were you or a loved one diagnosed with lung cancer? If so, we urge you to call the number on your screen now for a free legal consultation. Some lung cancers, along with the other cancers listed on your screen, may be linked to asbestos exposure. Exposure to asbestos in mills, factories, or while working as a plumber, electrician, plasterer, maintenance worker, or janitor may have put you at risk. In addition, because asbestos was widely used on ships, those working in shipyards, including Navy veterans, may have also been exposed. Asbestos has been used in many commercial applications, including insulation, fireproof fabrics, automotive parts, building materials, and small kitchen appliances. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with lung cancer or another asbestos-related cancer, call now for a free legal consultation. You may be entitled to compensation. Call 1-800-727-4905. Again, that's 1-800-727-4905.
Wayne Larrabee, Chris Martin, Carissa Thompson, 14-6 Wisconsin. Just over 4 minutes to go here till halftime. And stay tuned, Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Dave Howard, Jerry, be along with all the scores and highlights from today's opening weekend of Big Ten action. First down for the Huskies at their 16, Miko Brown. Oh, and he fumbled it. And Mike Taylor's got it. Wisconsin ball. Just inside the 25 of Northern Illinois.
When you're running back going between the tackles, it's all about ball security. You have to protect the ball. And Mike Taylor, we talked about how lathered up the coaches are about him. He goes in there and creates it. You know, he just went in there and ripped the ball out. And this kid, it just, every time a big play is made, it always seems to point back to Mike Taylor. That's exactly what the coaches love about him.
You know, they use, in practice, they take running backs and put them through a gauntlet of defenders who are trying to rip the ball away. That's exactly what that looked like, one of those drills where the linebacker reaches in and tries to pull the ball away. Scott Tolzien back into the lineup at quarterback for Wisconsin.
Is under further review.
And this play being reviewed by the crew upstairs. The technical advisor is Tom Herbert. Remember, all plays basically are reviewed, Chris, in the course of a college football game. Coaches get one challenge per game. And if they are correct in that challenge, they would get another one.
And here's what's so heady about that play for a young guy is that he first off made sure the tackle was secured. The tackle secured, you see it right there. Then he goes in and rips the ball out. Yep. A lot of time, young guys, they don't secure the tackle. They try and rip it out, and the running back's out the gate.
The question is, was Miko Brown's knee down? And I think from the angles we've seen, it's real hard to tell. Maragus got there first.
And remember, it has to be indisputable.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. First down, Wisconsin.
They need indisputable video evidence to overturn a call on the field, and they just didn't have it there.
That's exactly right.
And in fact, the pictures we saw, Chris, would confirm that it was a fumble.
And boy, if you're Northern Illinois, now things start to ratchet up. You found yourself just about in your red zone. Wisconsin now, you'd like to see them, if you're a Badger fan, go ahead and put the foot on the throat.
Off the first turnover of the game, Wisconsin first and 10 at the Northern at 24. Tolzien hit as he throws it over the middle, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by the linebacker, Corey Hansen.
Did the defense have a chance to get water yet for Wisconsin? Sudden change. Big play.
I think it was Patrick George on the blitz off the corner that got to the quarterback.
Boy, George, he's been all over the field. I mean, he got exposed early, but he's come back and made some tremendous plays for the defense of Northern Illinois.
So one turnover begets another, and it's Northern Illinois back on the field again offensively. First and 10 at their 17-yard line.
The ball's like a hot potato. No one wants to hold on to it.
We've had a lot of action in this first half, haven't we? Been a good one. This is the option. Harnish taken down. You know, McFadden made this tackle there. I don't get the feeling that Wisconsin has been fooled a whole lot defensively so far.
No, not at all. They're certainly locked into what they're doing. It's pretty vanilla coverage. They're not doing anything overly sexy for Wisconsin. They're lining up base defenses and just playing football. But if you're Coach Bielema, you know that's a costly turnover. See if your defense can come in and get a stop.
Second down. Harnish on the roll, got by Watt. Palmer St. Jean hit him in the pass, thrown away out of bounds. They were coming in waves. St. Jean, the middle linebacker, got through. And Harnish had vacated the tackle box and got the pass away toward the line of scrimmage on the far sideline.
And that's a great play by Chandler Harnish to get rid of the ball. When you're feeling that pressure, throw it in the stands. Give a souvenir away. Get rid of it. Saved his team about 9 yards. Nothing there, nothing there. Get rid of the football.
Couple of freshman receivers on the field. Perez Ashford and Martell Moore for Northern. Three receivers at the top of your screen. That's Moore at the bottom. Third down.
Play game. Number 12 offense. 5 yard penalty. Remains third down.
I was about to say it was deafening out there. The noise from the stands here at Camp Randall.
And that's one that'll drive a coach mad. See Coach Kill.
Football fans, you can create your own football highlight reels each week with the Big Ten Football Mashup, presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. Go to mashup.bigtennetwork.com right now to compile your favorite plays and share them with your friends. First penalty against Northern Illinois makes it third down. Third and 12 at the Husky 15.
It's a bluff.
Good protection. Harnish over the top. Penalty marker down. Pass play broken up. Henry back and forth with the freshman receiver Martell Moore. And it looks like it's going to be pass interference on Aaron Henry.
Bailed him out again, though, because if you're looking at Wisconsin.
Pass interference. Number 7 of the defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
If you're Wisconsin, you get everything you want. You get Chandler Harnish to convert this play to a fade route. A lot of grabbing and holding. Henry's in a trail position. That's an easy call for the ref. You see him with the arm bar. He's in a trail position. Ref right on top of it to make the right call. The official made a nice call.
First down at the 30. We knew what you were talking about, but we're all set. We got you, partner. Harnish. Oh, and he's got running room. And they close quickly, and a hard hit absorbed by Harnish from Mike Taylor, the linebacker. Gain of 4. And Taylor may have gotten the worst of that. He got up rather slow. Harnish kind of bounced up, went back to the huddle. There's Mike Taylor. Been kind of injury riddled. And Chandler Harnish, we talked of him in the open. A good dual threat quarterback. As dangerous with his feet as he is with his arm.
Yeah, some quarterbacks just have that escapability gene. He's certainly one of them. He can get out of trouble and make a bad play a good play.
Taylor looked like he got his head turned back by friendly fire. Not a whole lot there. Pickup of a yard to the 35-yard line to the third down coming up. And the carry by Chad Spann, the junior from Indianapolis in Indiana.
Wisconsin's doing a nice job of mixing up their coverages. They're making a lot of blitz looks. So it's a little bit of disguise. They're getting Chandler Harnish to check out of the call play and convert those. See what they do here.
NIU 0 for 4 on third downs. Incomplete. Trying to hit Ryan Palmer on the seam route. Pretty well covered. Maragoose was back there at the safety spot. And they also had the quarterback Devin Smith in the neighborhood. So it is a fourth down.
So far, nice job by Wisconsin linebackers of getting depth. When you talk about losing Casillas and DeAndre Levy of a year ago, they were very athletic linebackers. Interested to see who would step in. St. John Taylor, Javer McFadden, starting to fill those shoes.
Josh Wilbert getting punt formation. Gilreath back deep. And a fair catch at the Badger 24-yard line. Big Ten fans around the globe will be able to watch their favorite football teams this fall with Big Ten Ticket, the Big Ten Network's new international streaming package. All televised Big Ten Network football games will be available live and on demand online to viewers living outside of the United States and Canada on www.bigtenticket.com. So tell your loved ones overseas, they won't miss any of the action. Time out of the field. Badgers have played on the lead all night.
Where were the 23rd.
I told you I was on Route 30 heading west in my car.
You're lying! You killed a man!
No, I didn't. I'm telling the truth.
You're not telling the truth, and this courtroom deserves to know!
Jordan, what are they doing?
Badgering the witness.
What's the point? I mean, we're in Wisconsin this week,
so. That's their mascot, badgering the witness. Keep going, this is great.
I need to know the facts!
You can't handle the facts!
Big Ten Friday Night Tailgate, presented by Rotel and Velveeta.
Want to attend the bowl game of your choice in VIP style? Presenting the Bowl Bound Sweepstakes, brought to you by Rotel and Velveeta. You could win an incredible grand prize package featuring bowl tickets, air and hotel accommodations, $1,000 in spending money and more, or great weekly prizes. To enter, register at Rotel.com or text Rotel to 20284 from your cell. Don't miss out. Enter the Bowl Bound Sweepstakes today at Rotel.com.
Welcome back to Camp Randall in Madison. Wisconsin takes over with time winding down to this first half. First and 10 at the Badger 24. This is Tolzien. Nick Toon to the 39-yard line, make it the 38. And it's a first and 10, 14-yard gain. Decisive throw by the quarterback, Scott Tolzien, who's been just about letter perfect here tonight for Brett Bielema.
Talk about Nick Toon, too. You see Tolzien's numbers there have been accurate. Watch him pluck this ball. This is how you measure a good receiver. Catches the ball away from his body and pulls it in. Excellent job. Not using his body, using all hands.
First and 10. That's Toon at the bottom of your screen. To Brown in the flat. Oh,
good.
One-on-one open field tackle made by Kyrie Daniels, the quarterback. That was well done.
Yeah, great fill. It was a dump off route. Tolzien made the right play. He hit the check down back, but just an even better play by Kyrie Daniel.
Badgers have two timeouts remaining. Tolzien, oh, misdirected. My goodness. It looked like Jordan Delegal got a piece of it. Pass intended for Garrett Graham.
Garrett Graham, you can tell. Well, let's take a look at the Mike Taylor. You'll see it there.
And we're seeing that play. Mike Taylor suffered a rib contusion on that play on the last series for Northern Illinois. And he's had injury problems in his career. He's redshirted last year due to injury. And hopefully he won't be out very long with that. Apparently he's going to be back now. We get word that he'll be back in the game eventually. Third down. Tolzien drills it to Graham, short of the first down. Good short tackling again by Northern Illinois, and in particular this time Delegal. Once again, 9-yard gain, but they're short of the first down. And a timeout, I believe, being called for by Northern Illinois.
Well, anytime you're going to tight end,
Northern Illinois, they're first.
Northern Illinois.
30-second timeout.
Burn a tight end there. Tolzien, nice job, though, finding Garrett Graham.
Can the Huskies put some points on the board? We'll find out when we come back.
I was born and raised in Wisconsin, and I will live and die a Badger. I love being a volleyball player here at Madison, but being a student athlete at Wisconsin means more. I've always been interested in the environment, and I'm in a program called Rethink Wisconsin that is recycling at home football games. Hopefully this will catch on across campus and will make a huge difference. I'm able to be an athlete that makes a difference. Big life, big stage, Big Ten.
For more than 100 years, the University of Wisconsin has been inspired by the Wisconsin idea,
which says the good work of the university extends to the boundaries of the state and beyond.
So the UW works hard to help build Wisconsin's economy.
Educate people of all ages.
Advance health and medicine.
And enhance the quality of life for all of us.
Hit it!
The University of Wisconsin-Madison. Forward thinking.
Brad Norman just killed a 45-yard punt, and they downed it inside the 10-yard line of Northern Illinois. So I was wondering if the Huskies could put a late drive together, get some points on the board as we head out to halftime. Well, it's going to be a little bit more difficult.
Yeah.
They are 91 yards away from a touchdown, and plenty of yardage away from field goal as well.
Yeah, and I imagine Coach Kill will keep it pretty safe here. Get into halftime. Yeah. You're trailing by eight.
Yeah, let's see. He's got trips to the bottom of the screen. Adamski on the snap, first and 10. Harnish able to get across the 10, stayed in play, out to the 14-yard line, gain of 5. Penelis made the stop.
Wisconsin's linebackers have been cheating up all game. So nice call by Northern Illinois just to spread the guys out, get them out of the box, clear up some of that congestion to see if you can create running lanes.
Second and 5. And it doesn't look like they're in a hurry to snap the football, and they're going to wind down this first half of play. A first half highlighted by big plays, the biggest of which was an 80-yard pass play on the first offensive snap of the ball game for the Wisconsin offense. 80-yard touchdown pass from Scott Tolzien to Isaac Anderson. That's how it started here tonight. The Badgers would add another touchdown to the board on a reverse by Isaac Anderson, a 23-yard run. And they've got the lead at halftime. Let's get down to Carissa Thompson.
Coach, defensively, you have to be pleased. You held them to 2 field goals. They were 0-for-5 on third down. What has to change defensively?
Well, we've gave them 2 possessions because of dumb penalties. You know, we had a face mask over here. We had a 3rd and 14 defensive holding at the line of scrimmage. We just can't eliminate those things. We got to play Wisconsin football, and that doesn't have that.
Offensively, a costly turnover near the red zone. I know you couldn't be happy with that. What do you tell your 2 quarterbacks at halftime?
Well, you know, the interception was a corner crash blitz. It's on the running back, I believe, to pick up the protection off that look. We all got to work together. 11 guys. Doesn't matter if 8 guys do it right, all 11 got to be on.
Appreciate the time. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Carissa. Spectacular night for college football here at Camp Randall Stadium. Badgers on top. Coming up, the halftime report. Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report when we return.
So here we are in the fourth quarter. No time left, and the touchdown is under review.
Hey, guys, what do you think?
We're not ready to go yet. Is there any way you can send this thing into overtime?
Yeah. No problem.
I don't know what he was looking at, but we're going into overtime.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
This could finally end it. Unbelievable.
For more than 100 years, the University of Wisconsin has been inspired by the Wisconsin idea,
which says the good work of the university extends to the boundaries of the state and beyond.
So the UW works hard to help build Wisconsin's economy.
Educate people of all ages.
Advance health and medicine.
And enhance the quality of life for all of us.
Hit it!
The University of Wisconsin-Madison. Forward thinking.
Just dropping by to give you a little friendly advice.
Nobody threatens Sam Crow.
You love the man. You learn to love the club.
You better be real careful how you navigate around this one.
Or what? You're gonna put a bullet in the back of my head, too?
Sons of Anarchy premieres Tuesday at 10, only on FX.
Maya, like many people, has too much credit card debt. How about you? Do you have $5, $10, $15, or even $25,000 or more in credit card debt? I'm Todd Cook, founder of 800 Credit Card Debt. We'll help you find a payoff plan you can live with, one that could work with your creditors to eliminate penalties, lower your interest rates, and even reduce what you owe. Call us, because you can pay off your credit cards and still have money left over each month.
Call 1-800-827-0135.
They've dazzled.
Well, if that isn't an outstanding performance, then I've never seen one.
And left some speechless. But only a select few can be called the best.
I'm Carissa Thompson. Join me every week as we list the top moments, events, and athletes of the Big Ten Conference's amazing history.
The Big Ten's Best, Friday at 8 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Welcome in the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. The Badgers on top of Northern Illinois, 14-6 at the half. Dave Revson, Jerry DiNardo, Howard Griffith. What do we think of the performance so far from Brett Bielema's gang?
Two things jump out at me. Tolzien can really spin it. I mean, he can throw the ball. And now I've seen both him and Phillips play a first half. You could see why he's won the starting position. And the run defense of Wisconsin was like it was a couple years ago.
Yeah, defensively, that was a big part of it. They're having to be able to step up and make some plays on the defensive side of the ball, particularly in the defensive line. I think they've done that. The quarterback situation seems to have worked itself out.
They've done a nice job, particularly on third down defensively. Illinois, Northern Illinois, I should say, yet to convert one of those third down opportunities. Couple of big plays for the Huskies here and there, but by and large, Wisconsin done a nice job shutting them down. That's why they lead it 14-6 at the break. Let's check out some of the other action. We all know about the adversity from Michigan this week.
Michigan.
And a little bit. How about Tate Forcier to Junior Hemingway? Forcier, the true freshman, 13 of 20, three touchdowns. We were talking all day. The Michigan just wanted to come out and play. There's Denard Robinson, the other true freshman quarterback with the shoelaces untied. He drops the snap, and he turns it into a touchdown.
Just long enough for everyone to freeze.
He's just breezing by everyone.
43 yards, 31-7. The Wolverines roll in emphatic fashion against a pretty good Western Michigan team. Illinois and Missouri, the border war, and yikes. Blaine Gabbert, Wes Kemp. Gabbert threw for 313 yards. They've already forgotten about Chase Daniel. And then Gabbert hitting Jared Perry as Illinois, frankly, was completely outclassed in this game.
Without a question, look at the run here. There's not a defender even in the screen. That is definitely a problem.
37-9. The Illini now 0-7 all time in season openers against the Tigers. Navy and Ohio State. This one a lot closer than maybe a lot of people thought it would be. Fourth quarter, 29-21 in favor of the Buckeyes. Ricky Dobbs from 24 yards out. The middies cut it to two, so of course they're going to go for two. Dobbs has it picked off by Brian Roll, and Roll going back the other way 100 yards for a two-point conversion. 31-27 the other way. Ohio State, not the most impressive performance before they play SC, but they come away with a win. Northern Iowa and Iowa, wild game. Pick it up in the fourth quarter. Hawkeyes down 13-10, but threatening. It's Ricky Stanzi. It's Tony Moyaki back in there for Iowa and making his presence felt. Stanzi threw for 242. 10 catches on the game for Moyaki. Now Panthers down one, going for the game-winning field goal. It's blocked by Broderick Binns, but it doesn't pass the line of scrimmage, and it was on first down, and Northern Iowa recovered. And as we all know, that means he gets to kick it again because it didn't go past the line of scrimmage. This time they block it again.
Who doesn't know that rule?
Everyone knows
Dreaded
that rule.
Double ball.
Iowa State 17-16. Lots more to talk about on the first full day of the Big Ten football season. We'll show you how Joe Pa's gang fared. Minnesota going into overtime against Syracuse. All the highlights coming up.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few, the proud, the Marines.
At Big Ten Fan Camp, these kids wake up living and breathing Big Ten football. Our job is to channel that energy into the day's activities. Sometimes they call an audible on us.
If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the number on your screen now. You may be entitled to financial compensation. If you've been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call 1-800-690-3430 now. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer most often caused by exposure to asbestos. You may have been put at risk of exposure in shipyards or mills, in the Navy, or in industries like heating, construction, and automotive. Please, don't wait. We have successfully helped hundreds of victims and their families get the compensation they deserve. Compensation to help with treatment, medical bills, and care. Call 1-800-690-3430. For your free, no-obligation information packet and free legal consultation, that's 1-800-690-3430.
Tomorrow night, there's only one show that covers everything Big Ten. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Mike Hall and Melanie Collins bring you a complete recap of the week that was across the conference. Highlights, in-depth interviews, football analysis from Chris Martin, and your first look at what lies ahead next week. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Tomorrow night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Back at the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report, Akron and Penn State. This game was not particularly close. Joe Paterno back on the sidelines after the hip injury kept him in the press box for most of last year. Daryl Clark, Derek Moy. Clark threw for 353. Penn State cruises 31-7. Michigan State hosting Montana State. Kirk Cousins started at quarterback, and both the quarterbacks look good. Actually, they combined for 5 touchdown passes, no interceptions. Cousins here to Blair White. Michigan State wins it 44-3. Northwestern and Pat Fitzgerald taking on Towson. This also not a particularly close game. Second quarter already 21-0. Dan Persa, the backup quarterback, in there to Andrew Brewer, the converted quarterback. 72-yard touchdown pass, most points for the Cats in an opener since 1944. They roll 47-14. First game for Danny Hope at Purdue, taking on Toledo, and a decidedly different look for the Boilermakers. They got it done on the ground. Ralph Bolden going 78 yards. He had 234 rushing yards. Purdue had 315 as a team, and they win it and win it handily, 52-31. Minnesota going to the Dome to take on Syracuse, and former Duke point guard Greg Paulus will cut right to the chase. This one went to overtime. Paulus under pressure on a third down. Throw it away, throw it away, throw it away. He didn't throw it away. Was intercepted in the end zone by Brandon Triplett. Paulus should have thrown it away. So now Minnesota just needs a field goal to win it. Eric Elistad, straight and true, and the Gophers go on the road and pull out a win, 23-20. So good win for Minnesota. All right, let's talk about the big picture day so far in the Big Ten. Obviously, the only game not in the books, this one between Wisconsin and Northern Illinois. First of all, Michigan. What a story. I mean, all the adversity this week, and they come out, Coach, and what'd you make of that performance?
Most impressive. Good to see a bunch of guys just put all the nonsense behind them and be focused on the game. Over 400 yards. Tate Forcier was fabulous. They're playing the game in the space, and that's the way Rich Rodriguez has it designed.
You mentioned nonsense. That's kind of that Illinois-Missouri game when you kind of look at that. I mean, that was an absolute disaster. Couldn't find a way to move the ball offensively. They've got some problems down there in Champaign.
Yeah, the defense, really, you know, at some point, they've got to improve. It's the same mistakes over and over again.
Ohio State gets taken down to the wire by Navy. Are they ready for SC? Can we conclude anything from that game?
No, they're not ready, but they've got 6 days of practice starting tomorrow. I mean, they'll close the gap. Hey, maybe this was a blessing. Maybe this is the right attitude they needed to go into the week of preparation with.
I tell you this, they better find a way to dominate the line of scrimmage on the offensive side and the defensive side if they want to have a chance next week.
That is something they did not do in this game against Navy. Understand the middies running against you because they do it against everyone. But Ohio State wasn't able to pound it against Navy, and you might have expected that. Well, so far, Wisconsin, by and large, having its way with Northern Illinois, 14-6. Second half coming up.
For a limited time only. Lease a 2010 XF for $599 at your local Jaguar dealer.
For more than 100 years, the University of Wisconsin has been inspired by the Wisconsin Idea,
which says the good work of the university extends to the boundaries of the state and beyond.
So the UW works hard to help build Wisconsin's economy.
Educate people of all ages.
Advance health and medicine.
And enhance the quality of life for all of us.
Hit it!
The University of Wisconsin-Madison. Forward thinking.
Back.
This isn't an ordinary race.
This year's going to be better than ever.
25 champion drivers.
You can't miss this.
On dirt, bragging rights on the line.
Tony got lucky last year.
This is the Prelude.
We're on a new mission.
Help us support military families and injured soldiers.
We're all in this together.
The 5th annual Prelude to the Dream.
New charity, same race.
Wednesday, September 9th.
Don't miss it. Live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View, Channel 121.
Everything I do is to protect what we got.
How do we want to do this?
You love the man. You learn to love the club.
Just dropping by to give you a little friendly advice.
Nobody threatens Sam Crow.
Sons of Anarchy premieres Tuesday at 10, only on FX.
Log on to BigTenNetwork.com and register for the Big Ten Superfans program. Sign up and you can win tons of great prizes by watching the Big Ten Network. Show your passion. Become a Big Ten Superfan today.
Thursday on an all-new Big Ten Quad, Eddie George sits down with Fred Williamson, Paul Molitor, and LeVar Arrington. The Big Ten Quad, Thursday at 8 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Welcome back to Camp Randall Stadium. The homestanding Badgers leading at halftime over Northern Illinois. Wayne Larrabee, along with Chris Martin, will of course hear again from Carissa Thompson, who's down on the sidelines. A lot of questions coming into this opener about Wisconsin. Are you starting to find some answers?
Well, you are, particularly in the trenches where you wanted to see them be strong at the point of attack. You talk about Northern Illinois, their inability to convert on third down. They've been over five and stubbed their toe. But you gotta love the offensive dexterity for the Badgers. They come out, Tolzien finds Isaac Anderson on a breakdown by Northern Illinois, then hits him on a reverse play. He's showing his speed and ability to sniff out the end zone. And I thought defensively, Wisconsin really stepped up. They were swarming. Saw J.J. Watt making plays on the other side of the ball, which is always good. Guys chiming in on the action. Anthony Henry showing that he's back and solid. And then, of course, O'Brien Schofield flashing big plays. For Wisconsin defensively, they stepped up, but now they got to continue to close and keep on fighting. Nico Brown, we saw him snap off a big run early. So for Northern Illinois, they have to convert on third downs. Someone's got to make a big play.
Northern Illinois only had 129 yards in that first half. Nico Brown had 64 of those yards. In the gloaming in the state capital, Madison, the Badgers lead at halftime.
You and I must make a pact. We must bring salvation back. Where there is love, I'll be there. Don't you know, baby, you, I'll be there. I'll be there.
Made from fresh tomatoes living happily together with spicy green chilies, the bold flavor of Rotel gives your queso a kick. Spice things up with Rotel.
When the game is over, stick around for the State Farm Wrap-Up. In-depth highlights from the entire conference and complete analysis from our college football experts. The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
Hi, I'm John Chair, CEO and founder of Video Professor. I'm the guy that gives away all the free computer learning lessons. Well, I've given away hundreds of thousands of my lesson on eBay, and I'm not done yet. Call right now to get your free lesson on how to buy and sell on eBay. Now, I'm not going to tell you that I can make you the next millionaire selling an attic full of baseball cards, but I can guarantee you I'll teach you everything you need to know about eBay. Now, I can do this because I know that once you try my lesson on eBay, you'll come back to Video Professor for all your computer learning needs. And with over 60 lessons on all of today's most popular computer programs, I know that there's more you're going to want to learn. Don't wait. Call now and I'll send you my lesson on eBay or any other lesson of your choice absolutely free. Try my product.
Don't wait another second to improve your life. Get eBay, Windows, Excel, or any of Video Professor's easy learning CDs for free. Call now to get the skills you need to succeed. Call 1-800-223-9053. 1-800-223-9053.
Day afternoons, catch a can't-miss block of programming on the Big Ten Network. Beginning at 3 Eastern, go on campus to see what's new across the Big Ten with 2 full hours of the University Showcase. Then at 5 Eastern, get the inside story on the football season from the men in charge with an hour of coaches' shows. And at 6, relive the magical games from years past on the Big Ten's greatest games. It's all weekdays starting at 3 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
All season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the history and tradition of the Big Ten Conference. Let's take a look at the Wisconsin tradition of jump around. Between the third and fourth quarter of every home game, Wisconsin fans literally shake Camp Randall while dancing around to the House of Pain song, Jump Around. The tradition started on Saturday, October 10th, 1998, at the Badgers' homecoming game against the Purdue Boilermakers. After no offensive points in the third quarter, and en route to their second 6-0 start of the modern football era, one of the Badgers' marketing agents, who was in charge of sound, piped the song through the loudspeakers. It riled up fans and players and has become a tradition of the last decade.
Wisconsin went one better, a couple better. They hit the high notes. 80-yard touchdown pass to start the first offensive series of the season for the Badger offense, and 247 yards of offense in that first half. And then Isaac Anderson, who caught the touchdown pass, then it scored on a 23-yard reverse. And that's been the two big scores for Wisconsin. They've got the lead, and they'll get the ball to start the third quarter. Great to have you with us, along with Carissa Thompson and Chris Martin, Wayne Larrabee from Camp Randall. This is David Gilreath. Penalty markers all over the play. Gilreath collared high across the 30-yard line.
So flags flying, helmets flying.
It may be for illegal block by Monty Ball, a freshman running back.
Illegal block in the back. 33 in the return. Half a distance to the goal, first down.
And that was not the illegal block we were talking about. And I believe he called number 33 on the field. There it is, right there.
You see it right there?
I think that was number 31, so there are duplicate numbers. I mean, it's number 31 is Prince Moody. I beg your pardon, not Monty Ball. Prince Moody. And that helps spring Gilreath a little bit.
How about welcome to the party on that shot? he'll tighten that strap up the next time, don't you think?
Brett Bielema said, told his team yesterday, he said, you know, you guys better tighten your chin straps. This is going to be a Big Ten type game. And I think Jerry Kill is probably telling his squad the same thing.
John Clay on the carry.
John Clay gets the start of the second half at running back, gets 2 yards there.
Didn't we expect to see Clay peppered in? Zach Brown's been the workhorse back. He's averaging 5 yards a carry in the first half. But Clay was averaging 3.8, so you expect him to get the ball, particularly when they're trying to run inside on Northern Illinois' defense.
We might also see the freshman, the true freshman, Monty Ball, number 28, who's had a very good fall camp. Clay again. Trying to keep his feet, got out to the 15-yard line. That's a gain of 5. Third down coming up. Chris, let's revisit your keys.
Well, we talked about Northern Illinois matching the physicality. Can they hold up in the perimeter They've swarmed to the football and playing on the perimeter. What I want to see more from Northern Illinois is roll out passes with Chandler Harnish. Get him outside of that tackle box. Wisconsin, we talked about what can Brown do for you. Zach Brown stepped up. Again, he's averaged 5 yards a carry. And then defensively, they've shown a new identity to replace all the departed players from the season ago.
Third down and three. Kendricks in motion to the backfield. Here's Tolzien. Nice look over the middle. This is Toon to the 30. And barreled out of bounds. Crossed the 35. Nick Toon, and you hear the call of Toon, Toon from this Wisconsin crowd. 22-yard gain to a first down.
Nick Toon just looks the part. Big physical guy that can catch the ball in traffic. And he's developing a little swag. And that's what they want to see. See him working the crossing route. Gets in front of the ref, in front of the linebackers. But what I like most is he plucks the ball out of the air. He doesn't let it work into his body.
First and 10. Toon, the man in motion. Clay, the lone back. Tolzien, wide open, got his man. Inside Husky territory for another first down. Tolzien has been afforded good protection, and he hits Garrett Graham once again for 18 yards and a first down.
Great protection, but this is the best ball he's thrown all night. He's delivered this pass before Graham was even out of the break, right in between four guys. That is picture perfect for Tolzien. That was the best play he's had so far tonight.
Fifth reception of the night for Garrett Graham. Hendricks again in motion, this time to the offensive backfield. That would tell you run, and it is. Clay tripped up nicely. Boy, that was a great play made by Mike Sobel, the safety. A former starter who's been coming off the bench in this ball game for Northern Illinois. Gain of one.
Now we'll see Graham why he's so valuable. Look at him wash down the defender. Driving. Good stiff arm there by Clay. But this is what I want to see out of young Clay. Pick those knees up. Run through that arm tackle. He's 247 pounds. Can't be tackled by the first defender.
And the thing about Clay, he was a star sprinter in high school, part of a 4x100 Wisconsin State Finals team. He's got explosion. Tolzien, good protection again, this time a miscue. That's the poorest pass he's thrown here tonight. He has been spot on with just about everything. And that one, he missed wide open, Zach Brown.
Just naturally, you start showing him some love. And that's what happens. But he's been effective all night. And again, you can just see in his eyes, this one he just didn't deliver the ball where he should have. He has plenty of time. Go ahead and step into the throw.
Yeah, he didn't step into it. He was throwing that off the back foot. He used to be a guy in Green Bay who did that a lot.
Yeah, but he had the arm to get it there.
He had a stronger arm, slightly. Third down. Blitz. Oh, Tolzien here. Oh, what a pass play to Toon. Tolzien saw the blitz up the middle from Jordan Delegal, hung in there and delivered it right on the money for 21 yards to Nick Toon.
And you know what? You want to know why he's a starting quarterback? That play right there. He's staring down the barrel, knows he's going to get hit, but he delivers a strike to his guy, Nick Toon. And those are the things that you can't measure. We've talked about his arm strength, his limitations athletically, but that was courage.
Opening drive, second half, Brown got caught up in the traffic and got back to the line of scrimmage, and that was about it. Northern Illinois has held up pretty well at the flank, at the point of attack on plays right at the defense. Jake Kaufman, a defensive end, made the tackle there.
Yeah, good point, Wayne, and we're right about that point in time. It's 10, a little over 10 minutes, third quarter. Is that D-line wearing down for Northern Illinois? Will you start to see some plays pop out of attrition? Just guys being tired and being worn down by that massive offensive front by Wisconsin.
Take a look at the current drive. 67 yards, 8 plays. Taking the almost 4.5 minutes of this third quarter. Second down. Inside the 5-yard line, wide open. On that play for Wisconsin, Maurice Moore, 21 yards downfield. Tracy Wilson made the hit, first and goal.
Good little
seam route here, dropping behind that second layer right before the safety's able to get there is Maurice Moore. But look how comfortable Tolzien looks. Lets the play develop, doesn't rush the throw, gives his wide receivers a chance to make a big play. Coach has said it over and over. Wisconsin has to be better in the red zone. We'll get a good look at it here.
First and goal. Clay to the doorstep. Gain of about three to the 1 yard line of Northern Illinois. This is the opening drive of the second half. Northern has kind of hung in there. This would be a game-changing score.
Yeah, and this is where you want to see that dog in Clay. I mean, come on, sniff out that goal line. Big, strong downhill runner. That's your chance to punch it in there. You want to see him run with physical toughness.
This play. A score here would change the complexion of the game is what I meant to say. Clay, touchdown.
The big man showing you he can run inside, but he also has good footwork and can bounce it out on the perimeter. And that's where being agile at 247 pounds. Watch him bounce it outside. Nothing there. Good vision. Curtains.
20-6, Wisconsin. Point after try for Philip Welch. Touchdown drive of the game for the Badgers. This one to open the third period, and John Clay at a 1 yard touchdown gallop.
Sonic BLT and Tots for $2.99.
So great.
Great deal.
Yeah, fantastic deal. Good game today, too. A couple of nice quarterbacks.
I used to be able to throw a little bit.
Football?
Yeah.
Everybody could throw a football.
It wasn't the strongest arm, but I was accurate.
Ow, man. The heck was that? Great, now I have a Tot in my car somewhere. Thank you, TJ.
You'll find it.
Yeah, thanks.
$2.99 Crisonic BLT and Tots. New at Sonic. A medium order of Sonic's famous Tots, together with a BLT on a soft, buttery croissant. Now just $2.99.
It's time. From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides comes the 70-horsepower Sportsman 850 XP, the new Ranger 800 XP with 15% more power, and the all-new workhorse, the midsize Ranger 400. All now backed by Polaris Payment Protection, the only plan that makes your payments at no extra cost to you. Polaris, hardest working, smoothest riding.
This is our Saturday.
Our pride.
Our history.
This is our axe.
No, this is our axe.
This is our true color.
This is our halftime.
This is our tradition.
Our nation.
This is our time.
Our big house.
This is Big Ten football.
Big Ten football Saturday. All season long. Only on the Big Ten Network.
Along with Chris Martin and Carissa Thompson, Wayne Larrivee, welcome back to the state capital of the Dairy State, Wisconsin. Madison, Wisconsin, Camp Randall Stadium. John Clay carried the mail on that drive.
You can tell he's trying to be a star. See it there in his due.
11 plays, 92 yards on the scoring drive. To change the complexion of this game, 21-6, Wisconsin. Davis. Excellent hit made by William Hartman. And let's get down to the sidelines. Carissa Thompson. Carissa?
Well, guys, I caught up with Coach Kill at halftime. I didn't even have a chance to give you the report because Wisconsin did exactly what he hoped they wouldn't, and that's marched right down the field. He said offensively for Wisconsin, they were able to get those two scores off off of two big plays. As for them offensively, he's very disappointed. They were not able to convert on third down, 0-5, and he said it was a 3rd-and-5, a 3rd-and-6. They needed to execute and complete it, and he hopes that'll happen here in the second half for them to have a chance.
Thank you, Carissa. Lewis on the reception across the 35, gain of 9 yards to about the 38. Devin Smith responding from the secondary. The thing about Northern that you take a look at, they're not getting pressure on the quarterback. They missed Larry English, obviously. Everyone knew that would be a problem. But Carissa's right. They were unable to convert with their quarterback, Chandler Harnish. If you were to watch him for the first time, if tonight was your first look at him, you'd say, what dual threat are we seeing here?
Right.
Haven't seen it yet. Span. Mike Taylor, who was shaken up in the first half, back in there, first to the ball. And virtually no gain. Big Ten College Football brought to you in high definition by Phillips HD, available at Target, Walmart, and Sam's Club.
You know, Wayne, I'm a bit surprised that we're not seeing more designed runs by Chandler Harnish.
Exactly.
He was the leading rusher a season ago. I know that can be good news, bad news. You want to establish running backs, but let him be him.
Third down and short. Harnish to the air. Well, that was a wobbly pass. Penalty marker down. Intended for Marcus Lewis. It looked like Aaron Henry over the top. I'm not sure if that's the guilty party because there were a couple of Badgers in the neighborhood. But the ball was tipped, and that's why it probably came out of there sideways. I think they're going to pick this flag up.
Pass interference, number 7 on defense. Ball's placed, final foul, automatic first down.
Now the Badgers certainly want them to pick it up. They thought it was tipped. Let's watch it again, Chris. Can you see it?
Oh, that's a tipped ball.
It sure is.
There cannot be pass interference
exactly on
a tip. And this is almost a moot point. We know it's a tipped ball, so that eliminates. There you go.
Play is under review.
Good call. Make sure you get it right.
That's what instant replay is for.
Yeah. Look at the heads up though. How heady is that? JJ, I tipped the ball. That eliminates any pass interference. It's a good picture there. Good look.
Good look by our crew. Dennis Lanius, our director. Great crew of camera people.
Now, again, if that ball is not tipped, that's an easy pass interference call.
Yes.
Because he got there before the ball was there. So he did get bailed out, and that's what his coach is telling him.
Jim Ressler, our producer, they had all the shots in the truck, and the technical advisor, Tom Herbert. Take a look at it.
We'll see that deflection come right here if we can stop it. Yeah, we got a nice look at it. There's the deflection.
It's J.J. Watt, isn't it?
Yep.
All 6'6 of them.
That's what 6'6 will get you. Well, and they say on those short throws like that, the ball has a low trajectory. So if you can't get to the quarterback, go ahead and throw your arms up. What Watt did there, he's been impressive.
Yeah, he has, hasn't he?
Yeah, against the run stuffer, showing some burst off the edge. And again, if you think about the lineage of the DNs at Wisconsin, guys like Shaughnessy, you go back Erasmus James, they are not that big. They weren't that big. I mean, 6'6", just about 300 pounds. That is a monster defensive end for any team in the country.
Aaron Henry had a pass interference call against him in the first half.
He's been challenged a bit. And you want to see how he responds.
You come off an ACL on this level, and they're going to challenge you. There's no doubt. I mean, they know the story.
Sure.
Down there in DeKalb, not that far away from Madison. But this is what replay is all about, to make sure you get this call right. But Chris, I get the feeling the longer this takes, the more I'm wondering, do they feel like they have enough video evidence to make a change? And here's.
See that ball coming in wobbly. Remember, it has to be indisputable video evidence.
Jim Ressler, another look at that. Our producer and Dennis Lanius and our camera crew, it seemed like they were all over it, but they're taking their time. And Anthony Canella is our referee. We'll hear from him now.
After further review, Number 99 of Wisconsin tipped the football. There is no penalty for pass interference. All we have is an incomplete pass. Fourth down.
They got it right.
Give them their props. Deliberating, making sure they get a right call, understanding it's the critical point of the game.
NIU now 0 for 6 on third downs. So the lament of Coach Kill to Carissa Thompson goes on to this third quarter. And a truncated drive by the Huskies.
Truncated. Wow. Look at you. Watch Gilreath here. This is that spot where he can do some things.
Kind of a shank of a punt here. And it caroms out of bounds without a return at the 33 of Wisconsin. Badgers in command. Third quarter coming back at offense.
We believe there is something to be said for life and how you decide to live it. For the people you take in and the ones you take out. For the things that matter and the things that don't. For business, yours, and theirs. We are independent agents proudly representing Auto Owners Insurance Company, currently ranked highest in customer satisfaction for the auto insurance claims experience by J.D. Power & Associates.
So what's the problem?
These are hot. We're shipping them everywhere.
But we can't predict our shipping costs.
Dallas, Detroit, different rates.
Well, with us, it's the same flat rate.
Same flat rate.
Boston, Boise? Same flat rate.
Alabama, Alaska?
With priority mail flat rate boxes from the Postal Service, if it fits, it ships anywhere in the country for a low flat rate.
Dude's good.
Dude's real good.
Dudes.
Priority mail flat rate boxes, only from the Postal Service. A simpler way to ship.
Tomorrow night, there's only one show that covers everything Big Ten. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Mike Hall and Melanie Collins bring you a complete recap of the week that was across the conference. Highlights, in-depth interviews, football analysis from Chris Martin, and your first look at what lies ahead next week. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Tomorrow night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Big Ten Network's Big Ten Football 4-Pack.
What's the first rule of the 4-Pack?
Never talk about the 4-Pack.
Tuesday,
breakdown game analysis inside and out.
Wednesday,
sights and sounds, scoop for the Big Ten coaches.
Thursday,
behind the schemes, insider look at the X's and O's.
Friday, Big Ten Football and beyond. What's the second rule of the 4-Pack? Never talk about the 4-Pack!
Okay. This never happened.
Watch the Football 4-Pack every Tuesday through Friday night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Jerseys, hats, sweatshirts, and more. Get your Big Ten merchandise at our new online store and pay only $4.99 for shipping. Log on right now at BigTenNetwork.com.
Take a look at what's coming up this week on Wisconsin's University Showcase programming, only on the Big Ten Network.
Big Ten Network football is brought to you by Auto Owners Insurance. Highest in customer satisfaction with auto insurance claims experience, according to J.D. Power & Associates. By Sonic, it's not just good, it's Sonic good. And by the Postal Service, priority mail flat rate boxes, only from the Postal Service, a simpler way to ship. I was running right down there on that lakefront right there. Beautiful.
Putting in work.
Putting in work, partner. First and 10, Wisconsin. Tolzien to the air again. Toon coming back for it. Got a first down, 49-yard line of the Badgers. 16-yard gain. Chris Smith led the charge of Huskies, but Nick Toon has been very good in his route running.
Yeah, he has, and he's worked on his route content. Watch him push it up past the sticks, work back towards your quarterback, and pluck the ball out the air. He is continuing to develop into a polished receiver, exactly what the Badgers have been craving for.
Five catches now, 72 yards. Clay hitting the backfield and down he goes. That was Lawson, Brian Lawson, the big redshirt freshman defensive tackle out of Park Forest, Illinois. Reach East High School to make the hit. Loss of a couple.
That's good to see because those tackles hadn't made a lot of plays inside. Good effort play by Lawson.
Camp Randall Stadium on the campus of the University of Wisconsin, along with Chris Martin and Carissa Thompson. I'm Wayne Larrabee. Great to have you with us for this primetime edition of Big Ten football. Second down for the Badgers, about 12 yards to go. You've got press coverage on Anderson at the top of your screen. Tolzien wants to go that way, but goes over the middle instead and drills his tight end, Garrett Graham, once again to the 34-yard line of Northern Illinois, and they beat a good one, David Bryant, for 19 yards at a first down.
If Garrett Graham isn't the best tight end in the country, he's certainly in the top three. Watch him work in that crossing route, uses his body well to box out the defensive back, to give his quarterback a big target, showing you all facets of his game. Blocking, running routes, catching the ball out the air. Garrett Graham.
Nearing 6 minutes to go in the third. Zach Brown, the lone setback. Kendricks joins him. Now Brown. Hammered down hard by Mike Sobel, the safety who came over to close the gate. Pick up about four, maybe three, as they mark it just short of the 30-yard line.
Sobel is headhunting.
This is what we mean by he's a complete tight end. This is right after the big catch for the first down. Now he's blocking down there on the defensive end.
Mm-hmm. And doing all that at 6'5", 6'6".
Second down. Play action, Tolzien, all the time in the world, now being flushed. Tolzien gets it down to the 25-yard line, about a yard short of the first down. Gain of six. Brandon Bice tracked him down.
And if you're Coach Bielema, you actually like to see that because it shows you, is that clock going off in Tolzien's head to tell him to get out of there? And you could see that time he felt the pressure. Young quarterbacks particularly, usually they have to see the pressure. They can't feel it. That time he showed that he had good pocket feel and flushed out and got what he could.
Third down and short, John Clay. Got it, not by a lot, but it appeared he got the first down inside the 25-yard line of Northern Illinois. Well, I'm not sure if he got it or not, depending on the spot of the ball, but now they motion first down to move the chains.
And this is where you gotta look at the demeanor of Northern Illinois' defense. Guys on the field, are they wearing down? That's when you want to have a guy, know you don't have Larry English, but somebody to step up, corral the players and say, look, let's make a play and get off the field.
Badgers are now 6 of 9 on third downs. Clay on first down. Inside the 20 to the 17-yard line on a gain of about 7 yards.
Wisconsin, look at that double tight end set. And they run straight at you.
Yep, and they're doing it inside those tight ends. There's a group of five 300-pounders. So you got the two tight ends, and you have five 300-pounders in between them.
Oh, and they're saying, we know that you know what we're doing, but you still, we dare you to try and stop.
You know, it's
we
not don't like think you stop. They didn't lead the Big Ten in rushing last year. They, in fact, did.
Yep.
You'd never know it. And perfect in the red zone, have the Badgers. Play. Keeping his feet, spinning his way. First down to the 12-yard line of the Huskies. Pick up a five.
Well, we talked to Coach Bielema, chalk talk, if you will. We said, you know, what does your team have to do better? He said two things. One, be better this year on third downs, and also be able to score in the red zone. And this is where we're seeing, can Wisconsin finish the deal and punch it in the end zone? Don't settle for field goals. Get it in the end zone.
What do you think? They give it a big John Clay again. Nope. Tolzien's pass incomplete. Boy, he got some pass rush pressure in a hurry. They got Pat Schiller, the linebacker, the middle linebacker, right up the gut.
He takes a shot here. But the kid's shown some toughness and temerity. He'll hop. That's a big shot.
Watch this.
And he knows he's going to get tattooed. He sees that coming right at him. But what I like is he hopped right off the ground.
Second down, second and 10. Clay to the 10, down near the 7-yard line. Another 5-yard gain. John Quay has been featured here in this third quarter. Tonight's Polaris hardest working player is Isaac Anderson. He had the big first half, 80-yard touchdown reception, 23-yard touchdown run.
Hardest working is exactly right. He's been grinding. And what he's shown you is he is a great run after the catch receiver.
This is third down for the Badgers. Tolzien, Toon, leaping attempt and incomplete. Caught it out of bounds. Penalty marker down in the corner of the end zone.
That's the matchup you want. Nick Toon, good leaper, good body, uses it well. Excellent body control.
Ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. Pass interference on the defense in the end zone. Ball replaced to the 2-yard line, automatic first down.
Let's take a look here, just a fade route.
Yep.
Yeah, that's an easy call.
Patrick George got there a little too soon, a little too early.
See, at that point, the defensive back, Patrick George, has no idea where the ball is. I mean, he's just looking at the receiver. We can see it clearly there.
How about that catch by Toon? He hung on to that. Now, he didn't come down and bounce, but he hung on to it. First and goal. Kendricks in motion. Zach Brown. And they close the hole quickly. Schiller first to the ball carrier. Second down, gain of a yard.
These aren't gimmies. If you're in Northern Illinois, you're saying in that huddle, make these guys take another snap. Make them take another snap. Try and hold them at least to a field goal. But you just get the sense that Northern Illinois, their players are slowly wearing down. Again, they're up against a very big offensive line in Wisconsin. Give a lot of credit to those guys up front. They played well, particularly in the run game.
Turner is the fullback. Clay is the tailback. Clay, touchdown.
Wisconsin is showing you great balance on offense. We've seen them throw it through the airways, doing it on the ground. They have Brown, they have Clay now. Seeing him finish off runs, which is nice to see. Get a nose for the end zone. Overall, they look very improved over a season ago.
Philip Welch for the point after. John Clay's first touchdown of this third quarter changed the complexion of the game. This dive into the end zone blew it wide open with a minute 47 to go in the third.
So here we are in the fourth quarter, no time left, and the touchdown is under review.
Hey, guys, what do you think?
We're not ready to go yet. Is there any way you can send this thing into overtime?
Yeah.
No problem.
I don't know what he was looking at, but we're going into overtime.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
This could finally end it. Unbelievable.
Made from fresh tomatoes living happily together with spicy green chilies. The bold flavor of Rotel gives your queso a kick. Spice things up with Rotel.
Next Saturday on the Big Ten Network, a new era dawns in Minnesota as the Gophers unveil beautiful TCF Bank Stadium with a primetime clash against Air Force. Next Saturday in high def, only on the Big Ten Network.
Hi, I'm John Scherer, CEO and founder of Video Professor. I'm the guy that gives away all the free computer learning lessons. Well, I've given away hundreds of thousands of my lesson on eBay, and I'm not done yet. Call right now to get your free lesson on how to buy and sell on eBay. Now, I'm not going to tell you that I can make you the next millionaire selling an attic full of baseball cards, but I can guarantee you I'll teach you everything you need to know about eBay. Now, I can do this because I know that once you try my lesson on eBay, you'll come back to Video Professor for all your computer learning needs. And with over 60 lessons on all of today's most popular computer programs, I know that there's more you're going to want to learn. Don't wait. Call now and I'll send you my lesson on eBay or any other lesson of your choice absolutely free. Try my product.
Don't wait another second to improve your life. Get eBay, Windows, Excel, or any of Video Professor's easy learning CDs for free. Call now to get the skills you need to succeed. Call 1-800-223-9053. 1-800-223-9053.
Welcome back to Camp Randall Stadium. Wisconsin on top 28-6 with a couple of long scoring drives. The latest being a 12-play, 67-yard drive. Previous to that, to start the third quarter, they went 11 plays, 92 yards. Davis, this time from the three. To the 25-yard line. First and 10. Stick around after the game. Complete analysis with the State Farm wrap-up. Get in-depth highlights from the entire conference with Dave, Jerry, and Howard immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network. In this third quarter, time of possession, you were talking about the wear down factor with Northern Illinois. Well, they've only had the football offensively, Chris, for 2 minutes and 12 seconds. The Badgers, on the other hand, 11:43 time of possession in this third quarter.
Yeah, can you say run game? They've been able to just pound away.
First down. Chandler Harnish remains in at quarterback. That's Palmer in motion to the backfield. Harnish on the option to Ryan Palmer. Got a good block from Landon Cox, who held his block enough to spring Palmer for a first down to the 36-yard line. Gain of just more than 10 yards.
Very effective play. And quite frankly, I thought we would have saw more of this earlier. Little option play, getting outside on the perimeter. Finding the crease in the Badgers.
First and 10. Spam. Bounced into his own blocking on that play. He ran right up the back of Jason Scheppler, his tight end. And then got spilled to the side. Picked up 3 yards, maybe four nonetheless.
You haven't seen much of Miko Brown.
Pretty good size fumble. Defensive line for Wisconsin as well. And we talked about their offensive line. It's huge. Defensive line has some decent size in it. And quickness. Harnish in a tight pocket. Chased by Watt. Incomplete off the hand of Kyle Scarb. Javery McFadden on him near the 40-yard line. Next Saturday, coming up on the Big Ten Network, we've got another exciting weekend of Big Ten action. Featuring the Penn State Nittany Lions, they host Syracuse, plus these other games. Check your local listings, and then in primetime, the Gophers open their new TCF Stadium as Adam Weber and Eric Decker take on Air Force. Coverage starts with a Saturday pregame show, 10:30 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Check your local listings for the game in your area. I'll tell you what, the Gophers had to go overtime at Syracuse to win today. Third down. Harnish, diving, grab Clark, and he trapped it incomplete. Something Northern Illinois could ill afford. Turning the ball back over to the Badgers. That time they came with the blitz.
Yeah, and guess what? Once again on third down, can't convert, has to make the play, and that'll just frustrate Coach Kill. You see it there. You get what you want. It's the play that you've designed. Works perfectly against the defense. Get the receiver to sit down, and he just can't stick it and make the catch.
Devin Smith on the blitz kind of blew that play up.
It's exactly what you want.
I'm going to review that last play. I'm going to take a look at that. Jerry Kill, the head coach of Northern Illinois, pacing anxiously. Let's see on this reception. Did he get the hand underneath the ball? Boy.
Looks to me to be a trap.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. Northern Illinois is challenging that play.
So it is not a booth challenge. It's challenged by Northern Illinois and head coach Jerry Kill. And he had a pretty good look at it over where he is on that side of the field.
Yeah.
Willie Clark looked like he got a hand underneath the ball. His right hand looked like it was under the ball as he hit the ground. Boy, some beautiful looks by our crew here tonight.
Sure is.
Well, again, You have to define possession here, Chris. And possession is that hand under the ball. Does he secure the ball? Does he use the ground to trap or secure the ball? No.
The field is confirmed of an incomplete pass. Northern Illinois will be charged a timeout, 30-second timeout.
Right. You know, that was real close. You could go either way with that.
Yeah, and that was the right call by Jerry Kill to challenge it.
Sure.
I mean, there's a point in the game.
There's enough question there.
Sure.
Perhaps the replay booth upstairs here didn't feel like they had enough video evidence to overturn that call on the field. So, fourth down for Northern Illinois. Fourth punt.
This is one of the most dangerous return guys in college football.
In this fourth punt of the night. And Northern Illinois, like Wisconsin, three back to protect the punter.
Uh-oh.
Gilreath makes the fair catch signal. What did you see?
I thought he was going to have a chance to return that one. But the right call.
41-yard punt. Fair catch signal went up real early on that one.
Yeah.
So Wisconsin gets it back. All they've done in this third quarter is drive the football. 11 plays, 92 yards, and John Clay capped it with a one-yard touchdown run. And then a 12-play, 67-yard drive. John Clay capped it with a one-yard touchdown plunge. New quarterback in the game once again for the second time tonight, Kurt Phillips, the redshirt freshman out of Kingsport, Tennessee. Phillips on the fake. How about that? There's the upside that intrigued the coaching staff so much. A little play action fake and then the bootleg for 20 yards at a first down by Kurt Phillips. 6'3", 215. He possesses the speed of a tailback and he showed it right there.
Well, he's extremely athletic, but if you're Chris Smith, number five, you're saying right now, my bad, because you cannot let the quarterback Phillips get outside. You must force him back in. The help is coming from inside out.
What do you cornerbacks say? You got to get wider than wide, right?
Exactly right.
That was a poor exchange between quarterback and running back and allowed the defense to flow to the football. Fourth quarter coming up from Camp Randall, Wisconsin on top.
Limited time only. Lease a 2010 XF for $599 at your local Jaguar dealer.
This is my small business specialist, Tara. I know landscaping, but I didn't know how wireless could help my business.
I just don't know how wireless can help my business.
Tara showed me how I could keep track of my employees in the field and get more jobs done faster. I was blown away. I'm blown away.
Only Verizon Wireless has small business specialists in every store to help you do business better.
We should get you a hack.
Now buy any BlackBerry like the new Tour at our lowest prices ever and get one free.
Hi, I'm John Scherer, CEO and founder of Video Professor. I'm the guy that gives away all the free computer learning lessons. Well, I've given away hundreds of thousands of my lesson on eBay and I'm not done yet. Call right now to get your free lesson on how to buy and sell on eBay. Now, I'm not going to tell you that I can make you the next millionaire selling an attic full of baseball cards, but I can guarantee you I'll teach you everything you need to know about eBay. Now, I can do this because I know that once you try my lesson on eBay, you'll come back to Video Professor for all your computer learning needs. And with over 60 lessons on all of today's most popular computer programs, I know that there's more you're going to want to learn. Don't wait. Call now and I'll send you my lesson on eBay or any other lesson of your choice absolutely free. Try my product.
Don't wait another second to improve your life. Get eBay, Windows, Excel, or any of Video Professor's easy learning CDs for free. Call now to get the skills you need to succeed. Call 1-800-223-9053. 1-800-223-9053.
Where were you the night of the 23rd?
I told you, I was on Route 30 heading west in my car.
You're lying! You killed a man!
No, I didn't. I'm telling the truth.
You're not telling the truth, and this courtroom deserves to know!
Jordan, what are they doing?
He's badgering the witness.
What's the point? I mean, we're in Wisconsin this week,
yes,
so.
Their mascot, badgering the witness.
Keep going, this is great.
I need to know the facts!
You can't handle the facts!
Big Ten Friday Night Tailgate, presented by Rotel and Velveeta. Tomorrow night, there's only one show that covers everything Big Ten. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Mike Hall and Melanie Collins bring the week that was across the conference. Highlights, in-depth interviews, football analysis from Chris Martin, and your first look at what lies ahead next week. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Tomorrow night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Big Ten Football Sights and Sounds, Wednesday at 10 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
Town for nothing, especially on a holiday weekend. Wayne Larrabee, Chris Martin, Carissa Thompson. Fourth quarter getting underway. Zach Brown starting it in style for the Badgers. Gain of almost 10 yards. Let's get on to Carissa Thompson with a special guest.
Very special guest. Heisman Trophy winner Ron Dayne. You are in town because you were just inducted into Wisconsin's Athletic Hall of Fame. First of all, congratulations. Quite an honor.
Oh, thank you. That was great. And just having fun. Came out to see the guys, and they're doing pretty good, so I'm happy about that.
It was 10 years ago that you won the Heisman and you were out on this field. Does it feel like forever ago?
Not really, you know, it just kind of feel like I could have been out here yesterday, you know, but it's great to be back and see these young guys playing hard and winning.
I'm sure Brett Bielema would love that. There's some very talented backs here, though, in Zach Brown, in John Clay. We saw Clay get into the back of the end zone. Piece of advice for them.
Hey, just keep running hard and don't fumble.
Speaking of running hard, you hold the D1 and Wisconsin's record for all-time leading rusher. I think if there's one guy who's an advocate of the spread offense and the way these boys play football now in the Big Ten, it's you, because that record is untouched.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And then with the guys leaving early, so, you know, hopefully they stay around. Hopefully one of my sons will break it.
There you go. We'll wish you the best of luck. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate it. Congratulations again on the honor. Absolutely. Enjoy the rest of the game, guys.
Thank you, Carissa. Great job. Ron Dayne, I could remember it like it was yesterday, breaking off 80-yard runs. I mean, a guy that big, Chris, we've seen a lot of great backs in the Big Ten, but a guy that big that could run that fast, was that explosive, that is very rare.
And that's who Wisconsin hopes Zach Brown and John Clay can become.
Just short of the first down for the Badgers, and Kurt Phillips on again at quarterback of this particular drive. Picks it up. Oh, and a penalty marker down away from the ball. And I see that Isaac Anderson lost his hat.
It's starting to get a little edgy down there.
I wonder if he got tangled up with Chris Smith, the cornerback.
He definitely did. There was some late pushing between the two. Chris Smith, remember, he gave up that big run a few plays back.
After the play, personal foul, five of the defense. It'll be 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Yep, that was the case. Chris Smith and Isaac Anderson.
And that's frustration, getting the best of them there.
Mm-hmm. That defense has been on the field a long time in the second half. Get a look at the play. This happened away from the ball. And Jerry Kill, a teaching moment right there with Chris Smith. First down for the Badgers at the 30-yard line of the Huskies. Not much there for Brown. Jake Kaufman, the Marine, and he's still a Marine, a corporal in the Marine Corps, made the tackle there. Look at the numbers, and boy, it was a big third quarter the Badgers had. A couple of huge touchdown drives. His third quarter stats, just 22 yards for NIU, and only 2 minutes and 49 seconds time of possession.
And you know, going back to what Ron Dayne said, and I loved it, he said he wants those young backs to run hard, number one, and not fumble the ball. And when you look at Wisconsin last year, they had 19 fumbles.
Yeah.
It was the most since 1988. So they worked on that very hard this offseason in preseason.
Turner in motion to the backfield. Kurt Phillips And gets the tight end, a short gain inside the 30. Carissa Thompson, I mentioned the ex, not the ex-Marine. Jay Kaufman is still a Marine, but he's playing for Northern Illinois tonight.
You're absolutely right, Wayne. In fact, after his senior year of high school, he enlisted in the Marines. He served 15 months in Iraq and a total of 2 tours. He wears a wristband, you guys, and it reads, "For the Fallen." He says he plays every down for his friends that are still overseas. He has a greater appreciation for the sport of football and definitely a different perspective for being out here. Someone asked him if he was looking forward to playing at Camp Randall. They said, "Big stage." He said, "Yeah, it'll be cool. I mean, not as cool as jumping out of a helicopter, but yeah, it'll be cool."
You know, he was mentioning when his helicopter, his first tour duty, arrived in Baghdad, they were getting shot at. He saw the mortar come right through past the window, and he said, "Boy, now that's a reality check. My goodness."
And you become an instant leader.
Timeout on the field. Just under 13 minutes to go in this one.
Good in green or white.
We really think you're terrific.
Come help us defend the Rock.
Well, I'm back at you.
Big W on the helmet.
You know about our Buckeye leaves, right?
No dome, no problem.
You'd look great in black and gold.
Purdue could use someone like you.
Do you like roses?
Look, our helmet's got wings.
Come to Ohio State.
Come to Wisconsin.
Indiana.
Iowa.
Purdue.
Illinois.
Michigan.
Northwestern.
Minnesota.
Michigan State.
Come to Penn State.
When the game is over, stick around for the State Farm Wrap-Up. In-depth highlights from the entire conference and complete analysis from our college football experts. The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Big Ten Conference and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the expressed written consent of the Big Ten Conference.
Welcome back to Camp Randall Stadium on a spectacular Labor Day holiday weekend. Wisconsin on top and driving. Third down here, about 7 yards to go. Phillips to Brown. And there wasn't much Brown could do there. There were Huskies all over that play. Tackle made by Alex Baxter, Brandon Bice. Talk about running backs, and we've been talking to a great one, Ron Dane, on the sidelines here. Join another great running back, Eddie George, former Ohio State Buckeye, for lively, unscripted conversations, untold stories, and personal experiences from Big Ten stars of the past and present. The Big Ten Quad returns Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Field goal try, 41 yards for Philip Welch. Just a bit outside the right upright.
Welch was a Lou Groza Award semifinalist a season ago.
And you know, we've got two kickers in here who are on the Groza Award list. Philip Welch, who you just saw a moment ago, and Mike Salerno, the fine kicker for Northern Illinois. Now, this one never really had a chance. Well, he almost got it to hook back in there. There was just no wind in the stadium, Chris, and he needed a little crosswind to blow that back in play.
Coach Bielema assumed he just put it right down the middle.
First and 10 for Northern Illinois. Chandler Harnish remains in at quarterback. Play action to Span. Harnish over the top. Got a man open. Oh, and that's the fullback Scarb down the sidelines, out of bounds at Badger territory. The 45, 31-yard pass play. Penalist forced him out. Kyle Scarb, a junior from Hawthorne Woods, Illinois, Lake Zurich High School.
One of the tough things for linebackers to see is Mike Taylor gets in a trail position is that wheel route. Excellent job by Scarb of finding it and converting for the quarterback.
Good example of that route. Along with Carissa Thompson and Chris Martin, I'm Wayne Larrabee. Here comes Spann around the end, inside the 40, gain of 8 yards, down to the 37-yard line. Wisconsin has it well in hand, as you can see on the score at the top of your screen, but what coaches look for, they're still grading film at this stage of the game, right? They haven't turned off the projector yet.
No, not at all.
That's Scarb, a running back at the top of your screen. They've emptied the backfield, put three receivers down below at the bottom of your screen. Now the fake to Scarb. Here comes Harnish. One of the few times we've seen the dual threat in Chandler Harnish, down to the 25-yard line, gain of a quick 12 yards. Jay Valai.
Sometimes I think coaches can overthink things. Now, we talked about last season, Harnish was a leading rusher. Certainly hope that he's not that if you're Northern Illinois this year, but you still got to let him play. I mean, that's just his DNA. He likes to move around and be athletic, use his legs. Don't shy away from that.
On first down, Harnish in the pocket, incomplete. Well covered was Landon Cox by Chris Maragos at the goal line. You know, the thing you were mentioning, and again, you know, I had an opportunity to talk to Matt Limegrover, the offensive coordinator for Northern. I expected to see Chandler Harnish a little bit more on the perimeter, especially in the passing game, didn't you?
Yeah, exactly. He's better when he's outside the pocket, throwing on the run. What he is not is a drop back passer. He needs to be moving around.
Second and 10. They screen it out. Chad Spann got a nice block inside the 15-yard line. Jason Onyebuagu sprung that play. The old Mac left guard got out in flank of that play, made a nice block, 12-yard gain, first down.
Oh, and he's a good one. 300-pounder getting out on the edge. Nice play call here. Look at Harnish. He lets it develop. Sees White get up the field. Just enough of
just
a block
enough, yeah.
On Taylor.
It wasn't a pancake. It didn't have to be. First down, Northern Illinois seeking its first touchdown of the game. Harnish able to get by O'Brien Schofield and take it straight ahead down to about the 8-yard line. Gain of 4, maybe 5.
Wisconsin, you really want to tighten up, close down those running lanes inside. Expect some type of draw play to Harnish to see if he can find a crease.
And Chris, you're a defensive back, you're a defender. When you get into a game like this, you've held a team off the scoreboard in terms of touchdowns for three quarters. You want to keep that going through the fourth, right?
That's it's a big a pride thing, absolutely.
Here's a quick toss, bubble screen. Willie Clark covered up. Oh, Maragos made a nice read and brought him down just short, or so it appears, of the first down.
And it gets back to why you work on these situations in practice. If you're Wisconsin's defense, this is why you grind it out in camp. This is why you sweat. This is why blood flies in camp, is to tighten up, keep Northern Illinois out of the end zone. They wanted to get, Wisconsin wanted to get better defensively in the red zone. Certainly going to get their chance here.
Late changes on the defensive line for Wisconsin. Third down, a yard to go. Harnish, option, Spann, and he's turned back. But it appears he's got the first down. Down to the 1-yard line, first and goal. Brian Schofield led the way. Javery McFadden was also there.
And if you're Wisconsin, you just think you're so amped up just to be hitting someone with an opposite color jersey.
Schofield made initial penetration, and then it was McFadden who made the hit. And he had some help from his friends.
Yeah, good job of fighting off the block by McFadden.
First and goal for the Huskies at the 1 of the Badgers. Spann, the phalanx into the end zone for the touchdown. So Northern Illinois gets a late touchdown and makes it a 28-12 game with 8:29 to go.
Great job by Northern Illinois. A good looking methodical drive down the field. Capping it off with a quick burst by Spann.
And just a sea of humanity. You know, he just got in there and behind the wave and into the end zone. Now, of course, they're going to go for two. Trying to make it 28-14, going for two. Scarb, the fullback. Spann, the tailback. Harnish, hit, fumbles the football. McFadden's got it, and he'll be wrestled down. Two-point conversion fails. Don't forget, the defense can score on a conversion try. We saw it at Ohio State on an interception today. We've got a break. Badgers still on top, but the Huskies get a late score.
Croissonic BLT and tots, $2.99.
Have one of those tots?
Yeah, you know what? I'll throw you one. Go long.
Oh, okay. Hey.
Go long, man.
Oh, long one?
Yeah, I'll really air one out.
Okay,
go
yeah,
long.
Let's go. Ready?
Yeah. Go long, man. Yeah.
$2.99 Croissonic BLT and Tots. New at Sonic. A medium order of Sonic's famous Tots, together with a BLT on a soft, buttery croissant. Now just $2.99. It's time. From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides comes the 70-horsepower Sportsman 850 XP, the new Ranger 800 XP with 15% more power, and the all-new workhorse, the midsize Ranger 400. All now backed by Polaris Payment Protection, the only plan that makes your payments at no extra cost to you. Polaris, hardest working, smoothest riding.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Made from fresh tomatoes living happily together with spicy green chilies. The bold flavor of Rotel gives your queso a kick. Spice things up with Rotel.
Tomorrow night, there's only one show that covers everything Big Ten. Big Ten Tonight, presented by Principal Financial Group. Highlights, in-depth interviews, and football analysis from Chris Martin. Tomorrow night at 10 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
I'm Carissa Thompson. Join me every week as we list the top moments, events, and athletes in the Big Ten Conference's amazing history.
The Big Ten's best, Friday at 8 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Big Ten Football Breakdown, presented by Polaris, Tuesday at 10 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
Big Ten Network football is brought to you by Rotel and Velveeta. Try Rotel and Velveeta's famous queso dip, the ultimate game day snack. And by Philips HD, made to feel, made to amaze. Philips HD, made to move you. Welcome back to Camp Randall Stadium. Gilreath lets this one hit on the one and carry him into the end zone. The Badgers were expecting an onside kick. Huskies just reached the board on a 76-yard, nine-play drive. A lot of action to the Big Ten. This is the opening weekend of college football. Indiana kicked things off on Thursday night, able to escape Eastern Kentucky 19-13. Minnesota had to go overtime with Syracuse. Navy put a scare into Ohio State in Columbus. Northern Iowa almost upset Iowa. Iowa had to block a field goal. Missouri was big over Illinois. And Purdue, Danny Hope's first game as head coach of the Boilermakers, a success.
Yeah, that.
And so far, the only loser in the Big Ten, the Illini, in that game played in St. Louis against Missouri, the annual border war.
Very worried about that Illini defense.
Yep, gave up a lot of points today. Tolzien back in at quarterback. Intercepted. Intercepted by Northern Illinois, and down goes Corey Hanson, the linebacker, near the 30-yard line of the Badgers. Second interception of the night for Tolzien.
Well, and this is a major league play by Hansen. When you look at the depth that he gets on this drop. Sink, 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 sink. Boom, get in the throwing lane. Excellent job. Just reading the eyes. Look at him, watch him reading the eyes of Tolzien, going up high, pointing the football. That is a textbook play by Corey Hansen.
That was an outstanding play by Corey Hansen, the redshirt senior from Minneapolis, Minnesota, De La Salle High School. A lot of Big Ten athletes have come out of De La Salle High School, both in football and basketball. First down at the 31-yard line of Wisconsin. Harnish. J.J. Watt. What a game he's had. O'Brien Schofield, the other defensive end, they met at the quarterback. Back at the 36-yard line, loss of five. Fourth sack for the Badgers.
My coaches used to say to have a party at the quarterback, and that's exactly what Wisconsin's been doing. Look at the convergence there by Schofield and Watt. And I tell you what, Watt is going to be something special. Yes. He has arrived. Look how big he is first. 6'6", 285. With that type of burst off the edge.
Pewaukee, a western suburb of Milwaukee. Harnish on the keep. Antonio Pinellas on the tackle, gain of four.
At a glance, you look at Wisconsin defense from last year and you think, all right, they lost Jonathan Casillas, they lost DeAndre Levy, so you'd say the linebackers would look less athletic this year, because certainly those guys were extremely athletic, but it's a fast-flowing defense. They're playing fast, they understand exactly what they're doing, and they're making plays from sideline to sideline.
Pinellas has had a good night off the bench. Just 1 for 8 on third downs for the Huskies. Harnish on 3rd and 11. And he's got his man inside the 20-yard line for a first down. It's the big tight end, Brian Beckner, at 6'4", 260, 14-yard pickup.
And guess who is pressuring him? Your guy, Chris Borland, coming off the edge.
Chris Borland is a freshman linebacker out of Kettering, Ohio. Now watch this now.
Top of your screen.
There he is, number 44. He's one of
he's
those.
5'10".
He's USDA grade A linebacker. Palmer. Oh, what a great play on the flank by Chris Maragos. The safety had it all the way. I will go back to the linebacker, Borland. Brett Bielema was telling us, you know, Bielema said to him one day, he said, Chris, how tall are you? And Borland said, I'm 5'10", and I'm kicking 5'10s, you know what.
That's exactly what he said.
That's a linebacker.
Classic.
Us together. Nobody else went up.
This is Chris Maragos, one of the captains.
Hey, man, let's go.
That was pregame, and he bumped up his Badgers. He certainly did.
Setting the temperament.
Harnish off the hands of Ashford and nearly intercepted. Perez Ashford, a freshman wide receiver. They lost their top three receivers from a season ago, and so these freshmen are going to be sprinkled in all year now for Northern. Now for tonight's Jaguar defensive performance of the game.
What's it, the whole Badger defense, they've been making plays on the other side of the ball, swarming to the football at every layer. Up front with the D-line, the linebackers have been running through clean air, getting to the ball, and the secondary has been converging as well.
Third down. Harnish got his man, Chad Spann, over the middle, down to the 5-yard line on a first down. 18-yard pickup, but he had a lot of time to make that throw.
They can punch this thing in here. Get a two-point conversion. They're down by 10. You'd like to see that fight in Northern Illinois. These guys have kept their fists balled up.
Yep. Martell Moore's at the top of your screen with Nathan Palmer. Harnish keeps it himself. Oh, what a play made on the flank of the defense. Well done by Javery McFadden, the senior linebacker out of Riviera Beach, Florida. Loss of three.
And interesting about McFadden, he was at Mike linebacker, middle linebacker season ago, probably playing a little out of position. So they bounced him outside, and as you can see there, it's a more natural position for him. He's been very active, seven tackles tonight.
He led this team in tackles a year ago, and he played with a broken hand. He played basically with one hand. Second down. Harnish. Perez Ashford, the true freshman out of Shaker Heights, Ohio, inside the five near the two-yard line, gain of six. Maragos got over to make the hit.
Confidence builder, though, for Northern Illinois' offense to construct a long drive.
And, Chris, also to get these freshmen receivers who are going to have to play a big role by the time the MAC season rolls around, get them involved.
No question.
Tight ends on the right side of the line. Tight end on the left as well. Oh, he wanted to option it. O'Brien Schofield hit the quarterback. Pried the ball loose. And I believe, are they saying Wisconsin ball or was he down by contact? I have not seen a definitive call by the officiating crew yet.
I think they're saying he was down.
I thought so, yeah. O'Brien Schofield with the immediate hit on the quarterback. Watch this. Chandler Harness didn't even have time to pitch the ball to Chad Spann.
That's a real quick read. Option, you got to read that much quicker. You got a guy running free. He's got to deliver the ball to the pitch man.
Play is under further review.
See, Wayne, when you go option football with a quarterback, the first read is the defensive end, which would have been O'Brien Schofield. But he gets to Harnish so quickly, even before Harnish could react and find the pitch man.
Well, we've talked about O'Brien Schofield. He's one of the co-captains.
If we can hold it right here. See the pitch man? There's the defensive end. Schofield's right in his face. He has to deliver this pitch to his fullback right away. He doesn't do that. That's why it gets pummeled. He actually was going to deliver it to his tailback there.
Yeah.
Span, yeah.
O'Brien Schofield, Chris, is, would you say, a bit undersized for a defensive end? I mean, he's a former linebacker, 6'3", about 245. But I think what helps him is the quickness that he used as a linebacker earlier in his career, now a defensive end, and making a play like that. That play has linebacker written all over.
Was really stopped on the play. Play is not reviewable. Fourth down, Northern Illinois.
Okay, so they decide the play is not reviewable. And Northern Illinois facing fourth down.
But to your point, Schofield is a hybrid. He's just under 250 pounds. So you know, as a former linebacker, he can run and get to the football. And in talking to Dave Doran, the defensive coordinator, he said he just has a good feel and fit at the D-line position. Much more natural for him than playing linebacker.
Well, it's fourth down, given the game situation, they're going for it. Fourth down, goal to go at the Wisconsin 6. Fade route. And a flag down. Pass intended for Willie Clark. Antonio Finellas had the coverage, and it looked like he had contact.
Yeah.
Pass interference, 26 defense. Ball being placed at the 2-yard line, first down.
2:52 left to go.
Little touchy, but again, the right call by the official. They've been on top of it today.
Is that contact?
Yeah, see the
kind of held him up. First down, goal to go. At the two. Beckner in motion. Spann following his blocking into the end zone. Touchdown. Second touchdown of the night for Chad Spann, the junior running back out of Indianapolis. 2:47 to go, and things begin to tighten up a bit here.
Good surge up front. Look at the blocking up front. Good lead block by the fullback, Scarb. Again, very well constructed drive by Northern Illinois.
going for it, and they've spread the field. Three receivers to the top, one to the bottom for the two-point conversion. Harnish alone in the shotgun, and he takes it on the run, and he's in for the two-point conversion.
Outstanding coaching and play call. How do you get those linebackers out of the box? You spread them out.
Northern Illinois jumps back into it. The touchdown drive makes it an 8-point game. We live to
ride, we ride to... So here we are in the fourth quarter. No time left, and the touchdown is under review.
Hey, guys, what do you think?
We're not ready to go yet. Is there any way you can send this thing into overtime? Yeah.
No problem.
I don't know what he was looking at, but we're going into overtime.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
This could finally end it. Unbelievable.
We believe there's something to be said for setting goals and achieving them. For dreaming big and getting there. For hearing biological clocks and listening. For clocking long hours, sacrificing, and succeeding. And for finally being able to say, welcome home. We are independent agents proudly representing Auto Owners Insurance Company, currently ranked highest in customer satisfaction for the auto insurance claims experience by J.D. Power and Associates.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. If your child was born with cerebral palsy or Erb's palsy, it may have been due to medical mistakes or exposure to chemicals during pregnancy. Caring for a disabled child can be financially and emotionally challenging. Call now as you may be entitled to compensation. Again, if your child was born with cerebral palsy, Erb's palsy, or any other serious birth injury, call 1-800-801-1664. That's 1-800-801-1664. Call now.
Maya, like many people, has too much credit card debt. How about you? Do you have $5, $10, $15, or even $25,000 or more in credit card debt? I'm Todd Cook, founder of 800 Credit Card Debt. We'll help you find a payoff plan you can live with, one that could work with your creditors to eliminate penalties, lower your interest rates, and even reduce what you owe. Call us, because you can pay off your credit cards and still have money left over each month.
Call 1-800-827-0135.
Jerry Kill has marshaled his Northern Illinois Huskies right back into this one. And now, Mike Salerno, one of the best onside kickers in the country. And you know what's coming up. Here it is. It's up for grabs. Northern Illinois recovered. Chad Spann, who scored two touchdowns in this fourth quarter, makes the recovery.
We talked about how critical special teams has been today for all the Big Ten schools. What an excellent kick. Watch the bounce. Great job in Northern Illinois. Hustling down. Collapsing the pocket there. And Spann being Johnny on the spot.
Hey, partner, there's still 2:46 to go in this game. Northern Illinois's got it. Down eight. 56 yards away.
This is why you have to finish the deal whenever you take the field.
First down for Harnish. Oh, and a nice throw for a first down inside the 45-yard line. On the reception, the freshman, the true freshman out of San Antonio, Texas, Martell Moore for 13 yards.
That was a great strike by Harnish. Watch the play action, hold the linebackers. Finds his receiver right in between four guys. Good ball strike by Chandler Harnish.
Harnish beginning to heat up. He didn't get much time on the field in the third quarter. The Badgers dominated. But here in the fourth, Harnish again, good protection initially. Now hit as he throws the right side, and it's incomplete. Martell Moore was in the vicinity of that incomplete pass. O'Brien Schofield helped to collapse the pocket.
And if I'm Matt Limegrover, I'm watching that guy, number 50, O'Brien Schofield.
I'm putting a tight end over there.
Yep, tight end or chip with the back to slow him down. He has too much edge presence.
Second down and 10. Empty shotgun now. Span moves to the offensive backfield. Harnish on the keep.
Harnish on the keeper.
Able to get down to the 39-yard line, wrapped up by Anthony Maines. And don't forget, folks, stay tuned. As soon as we're done here, the State Farm Wrap-Up Show for scores, highlights, and analysis of today's game. State Farm Wrap-Up coming up on the Big Ten Network.
Look at the tenacity. I love the energy of Jerry Kill. He is just wearing the sideline out, going back and forth. Never lost focus in this game. His players are demonstrating the same traits.
Third down. Harnish. Scarb. Schofield downfield. Made the hit. Just short of the 35 and the 36, gain of about four. Now it's fourth down and three.
Yep, this is money down. Bag of tricks. You got something that's going to get you there.
Got a timeout called on the field. The Huskies, remember, burned a timeout on a challenge that didn't go their way earlier in this second half. And now with this timeout, they have one remaining. The Badgers have three.
But this is exactly.
I beg your pardon, I have two timeouts remaining.
In Wayne, excuse me, but this is exactly why you have to play the next play always. Wisconsin, they had this team on the ropes, did not put the foot on the throat and take them out, and now they find themselves on their heels with Northern Illinois picking a lot of steam. And you have to wonder, what is Coach Bielema thinking right now? Consternation on his face. Northern Illinois, the second half, Chandler Harnish has been able to engineer long drive.
And Chad Spann has stepped up at the running back spot in place of Miko Brown.
Sure has. And they've made the plays when they've needed to make them. We'll see if they can make it here.
It is fourth down. Game on the line for Northern Illinois. Fourth down and three at the Wisconsin 36. Badger crowd in full throat. Harnish under a blitz. Broke it up, incomplete. The senior, the captain, Chris Maragos, breaks it up. Badger offense comes back onto the field. And remember, Northern Illinois has just one timeout remaining.
What a play by Maragos to be able to read and diagnose. Good close. Gets the hand inside. We talk about saran wrap tight coverage. It's exactly what you got. And Maragos has made plays all night. Run support, blitzing, coming off the edge, showing range in the secondary.
They were going to Scarb, the fullback, and now the Badgers in the victory formation. Tolzien drops to a knee. Again, one timeout left for the Huskies. They trail by eight. We have 61 seconds left to go. The Phillips HD player of the game is Scott Tolzien. And a look at his numbers. Now, he has had a couple of interceptions. One was deflected. But 15 of 22, 257 yards and a touchdown.
I think he's answering the biggest question mark for the Badgers.
Chandler Harnish in this fourth quarter has rallied the Huskies back into this ball game. Boy, after that third quarter, Chris, when Wisconsin dominated with two long touchdown drives, both double digits in terms of number of plays, you would expect the Huskies to head out of Madison with their tail between their legs, but that was not the case.
No, and Harnish has no reason to hang his head.
Tolzien drops to a knee. Northern Illinois powerless to stop the clock.
Northern Illinois is going to be a wrecking ball in the MAC. They come in here, fight, battle, show some resiliency, gets back in the game, puts Wisconsin up against the ropes, and it's all a reflection of the head coach, Jerry Kill. Again, an impeccable body of work. He's won every place he's been at. He has his players believing. In 2007, they were 2-10. Last year, they go to the Independence Bowl. And looks like they're destined for a great year this year.
Well, it got shaky in the fourth quarter for Wisconsin, but in general, the Badgers dominated this game for three quarters.
Yep. And answered a lot of question marks physicality, toughness, concentration.
Quarterback play.
The biggest question. Yeah. The biggest question in Badger country.
At least for now, they enter the quarterback play. Tolzien was very good. Phillips came in and did some good things with his feet, as we would expect.
And then the wide receivers, I thought they were very impressive. Nick Toon showed that he is developing into a polished receiver and the guy that he thought, that they thought he would be.
Wisconsin wins it 28-20 over Northern Illinois. Let's get on to Carissa.
Well, Coach, you want to make it exciting for the season opener. You, of all people, know how important special teams is. How much conversation do you have with your team about finishing?
Well, you know, the big thing is we went into the second half. We knew that we were going to be in for a four-quarter game, and that's what we got. You know, there's a couple things that added to the situation we're in at the end of the second half. But I like the way our guys responded. And good first game to get some things out from underneath us and move forward.
Six penalties, two turnovers, but Chris Maragos, he played an entire game. He was pumped up from the pregame. He's a captain for you. What do you have to say about his performance today?
Well, Chris, as we know, is a special player. He's got a lot of internal motivation, a strong Christian, and that carries over here out to the field, and it's a reason a two-year transfer guy's been named captain. He's got something inside him.
We saw both quarterbacks tonight. We thought we would. Tolzien, it took him one play, 80 yards and 11 seconds. What took him so long?
Well, we thought there'd be some things on film to get out of the gate, and, bottom line, he saw it, he threw it, and he made it happen, and then, the one that he'd love to take back is the end of the half here, but, it's a young team that learned and came out with a W.
Speaking of a very young team, I mean, this is your first chance to see these guys play out there. You go into each game with a game plan. How did it pan out for you?
Well, we wanted to go out and execute, and we wanted to see our players play and got better as the game got on. The biggest thing we'll be able to go in tomorrow, there's a lot of corrections that we need to make, and I think the staff will take an emphasis of, hey, tomorrow we need to be better than we were yesterday and move forward, and now we'll look on to Fresno State.
Great. Good luck next
Thank
week.
You very
Congratulations,
much.
Coach. That's a 12th consecutive W for a season opener for the Wisconsin Badgers. Guys?
Yeah, indeed. 12 straight season opening wins for Wisconsin. They haven't lost an opener since 1997 at Giant Stadium to Syracuse. A good start for the Wisconsin Badgers here tonight, all things told. Northern Illinois fought hard, gave them four quarters, as Brett Bielema said they would. 28-20, the Badgers come away with the win. Now for Chris Martin and Carissa Thompson, I'm Wayne Larrabee. Special thanks to Tom Hecker, our statistician, for our entire crew. Let's send you to the State Farm wrap-up and Dave Repson in our Chicago studio.
The first week of the college football season is done. The Big Ten got a lot of wins, just not a lot of style points. Dave Repson, Mike Hall on the State Farm wrap-up show.
That is for sure. All the highlights, all the analysis, including complete post-game reaction from Madison, coming up.
It's blocked again! The Hawkeyes did it again!
The pageantry of Kinnick Stadium! The heartbreak of college football.
Coming up on the State Farm wrap-up. After a week of adversity, the Wolverines come out firing. Is the swagger back in Ann Arbor? Some wild finishes throughout the conference, including Ohio State getting all it can handle from Navy. What does it mean for next week's showdown with SC? And Missouri was supposed to be rebuilding, but you wouldn't know it from their game with the Illini. What does it all mean for Ron Zook's team? We break it down on the State Farm wrap-up now. Northern Illinois and Wisconsin, the game you just watched in Madison. Scott Tolzien making his first career start, and this would be a good way to get started. Tolzien, Isaac Anderson, 80 yards later, he's in the end zone. Tolzien has the first touchdown pass of the season for the Badgers, and they are on top 7-0. To the second quarter, first play of the second quarter, in fact, it is Isaac Anderson on the reverse, 23-yard touchdown, and the Badgers looking good, on top 14-3. To the second half now, it's 14-6, and Tolzien down inside the five to Maurice Moore. Tolzien, 15 of 22 on the day. And then it's John Clay into the end zone. The Badgers on top, 21-6. Clay, 15 carries, 43 yards, couple touchdowns. This is the second one. Wisconsin up 28-6. Game over, right? Wrong. Back come the Huskies. Down 28-12. About 3 minutes to go. Chad Spann up the middle. And into the end zone. The Huskies cut it to 28-18. And then they get within one score after the successful two-point conversion. So it's 28.
Visit boosterseat.gov.
10-point margin in the Miami Hurricanes miss an opportunity. 32-yard field goal certainly within the reach of Andy Crossland, but he just yanked it. Left footer pushed it right. So the Bruins